Well, what about Shepard? She's a spacer, lived aboard starships most of her life.
Military service runs in the family. Both her parents were in the Navy.
She proved herself during the Blitz. Held off enemy forces on the ground until reinforcements arrived.
She's the only reason Elysium is still standing.
We can't question her courage.
Humanity needs a hero. And Shepard's the best we've got.
I'll make the call.
Thrusters, check. Navigation, check. Internal emission sync engaged. All systems online. Drift, just under 1,500K.
1,500 is good. Your captain will be pleased.
I hate that guy.
Nihlus gave you a compliment. So you hate him.
You remember to zip up your jumpsuit on the way out of the bathroom? That's good. I just jumped us halfway across the galaxy and hit a target the size of a pinhead. So that's incredible. Besides, Spectres are trouble. I don't like having them on board. Call me paranoid.
You're paranoid. The Council helped fund this project. They have a right to send someone to keep an eye on their investment.
Yeah, that is the official story. But only an idiot believes the official story.
They don't send Spectres on shakedown runs.
So there's more going on here than the captain's letting on.
Joker, status report.
Just cleared the mass relay, Captain. Stealth systems engaged. Everything looks solid.
Good. Find a comm buoy and link us into the network. I want mission reports relayed back to Alliance Brass before we reach Eden Prime.
Aye, aye, Captain. Better brace yourself, sir. I think Nihlus is headed your way.
He's already here, Lieutenant. Tell Commander Shepard to meet me in the comm room for a debriefing.
You get that, Commander?
Great. You pissed the captain off, and now I'm gonna pay for it.
Don't blame me. The captain's always in a bad mood.
Only when he's talking to you, Joker.
Congratulations, Commander. Looks like we had a smooth run. You heading down to see the captain?
Sounds like you don't trust our Turian guest.
Sorry, Commander. Just having a chat with Adams down at Engineering. I didn't mean to cause any trouble. But you have to admit, something's odd about this mission. The whole crew feels it.
You think the Alliance Brass is holding out on us?
If all we're supposed to do is test out the stealth system, why is Captain Anderson in charge? And then there's Nihlus. Spectres are elite operatives, top covert agents. Why send a Spectre, a Turian Spectre, on a shakedown run? It doesn't add up.
What do you know about the stealth systems?
I just know it masks our location from scans and sensors. Cutting-edge technology. The Normandy's the only ship with this prototype drive. But why are we fully staffed? A skeleton crew would be cheaper. Less chance of security leaks, too. Plus, there's Nihlus. It's pretty obvious this shakedown run is just a cover.
For what?
Damned if I know, Commander. We're out here on false pretenses. I'm not a fan of being left in the dark.
Do you have a problem with the captain?
No, ma'am. But I can't figure out what he's doing here. Captain Anderson is one of the most decorated Special Forces officers in the service. If he melted down all his medals, he could make a life-size statue of himself. You don't send a soldier like that on a do-nothing mission. He's treating this shakedown run too seriously. Something big is going on.
You don't trust Nihilus?
I don't like Turians in general. It runs in my family. My grandfather fought in the First Contact War. Lost a lot of friends when the Turians hit us.
Nihilus is no ordinary Turian.
You've got that right, Commander. We're an Alliance vessel, human military, but Nihilus doesn't answer to the captain like the rest of us. Spectres operate outside the normal chain of command. And they don't come along just to observe shakedown runs. Nihilus looks like he's expecting some heavy action. I don't like it.
I'll see if I can get some answers when I see him.
Good luck, Commander.
What do you think, Commander? We won't be staying on Eden Prime too long, will we? I'm itching for some real action.
I sincerely hope you're kidding, Corporal. Your real action usually ends with me patching up crew members in the infirmary.
You need to calm down, Corporal. A good soldier stays cool even under fire.
Sorry, Commander, but this waiting's killing me. I've never been on a mission like this before, not one with a Spectre on board.
What can you tell me about Nihilus?
Turians are generally well-respected by the other species. Their fleet has more patrols protecting Citadel space than any other. They don't always get on well with us, though. Some people find them too rigid. Others still blame them for the First Contact War. As for Nihilus, I haven't said more than two words to him. He usually only speaks to the captain.
I heard Nihilus once took down an entire enemy platoon all by himself. Man, I can't believe I'm on a mission with an actual Spectre.
What do you know about the Spectres?
Only what I've heard. Spectre agents work directly for the Citadel Council. They usually work alone or in small groups. Spectres don't have any official power, though. Basically, they're a shadow organization with a mandate to preserve and protect galactic stability.
Protect it at any cost. Don't forget that part. Spectres operate above the law.
Why don't we have any of our own people in there?
Spectres usually come from the Council races. Like the Turians. We've been trying to get a human accepted into their ranks for years now. So far, it hasn't happened.
Hey, Commander, you'd make a good Spectre. You're a war hero, right? Held off an entire enemy fleet during the Blitz single-handed? That's the kind of talent the Spectres are looking for.
This is all just wild speculation. The Spectres aren't interested in recruiting humans, no matter how capable.
You're from Eden Prime, aren't you, Jenkins? What's it like?
It's very peaceful, Commander. They've been real careful with development, so you don't have any city noise or pollution. My parents lived on the outskirts of the colony. At night, I used to climb this big hill and stare across the fields back at the lights from the main settlement. It was gorgeous. But when I got older, I realized it was a little too calm and quiet for me. That's why I joined the Alliance. Even Paradise gets boring after a while.
Any idea why Eden Prime was chosen as our destination?
Not really sure, Commander. Eden Prime's one of our most stable colonies. Good place to take the Normandy for a shakedown run, I guess. No real danger there. There's gotta be something else going on. We've got a Spectre on board. That's why I'm so wound up. I can't wait for the real mission to start.
Just treat this like every other assignment you've had and everything will work out.
Easy for you to say. You proved yourself in the Blitz. Everybody knows what you can do. This is my big chance. I need to show the brass what I can do.
You're young, Corporal. You have a long career ahead of you. Don't do something stupid to mess it up.
Don't worry, ma'am. I'm not gonna screw this up.
The captain's waiting for me.
Commander Shepard, I was hoping you'd get here first. It will give us a chance to talk.
What about?
I'm interested in this world we're going to. Eden Prime. I've heard it's quite beautiful.
They say it's a paradise.
Yes, a paradise. Serene, tranquil, safe. Eden Prime has become something of a symbol for your people, hasn't it? Proof that humanity can not only establish colonies across the galaxy, but also protect them. But how safe is it, really?
Do you know something?
Your people are still newcomers, Shepard. The galaxy can be a very dangerous place. Is the Alliance truly ready for this?
I think it's about time we told the Commander what's really going on.
This mission is far more than a simple shakedown run.
I figured there was something you weren't telling us.
We're making a covert pickup on Eden Prime. That's why we needed the stealth systems operational.
There must be a reason you didn't tell me about this, sir.
This comes down from the top, Commander. Information strictly on a need-to-know basis. A research team on Eden Prime unearthed some kind of beacon during an excavation. It was Prothean.
I thought the Protheans vanished 50,000 years ago.
Their legacy still remains. The mass relays, the Citadel, our ship drives. It's all based on Prothean technology.
This is big, Shepard. The last time humanity made a discovery like this, it jumped our technology forward 200 years. But Eden Prime doesn't have the facilities to handle something like this. We need to bring the beacon back to the Citadel for proper study.
Obviously, this goes beyond mere human interests, Commander. This discovery could affect every species in Council space.
It never hurts to have a few extra hands on board.
The beacon's not the only reason I'm here, Shepard.
Nihlus wants to see you in action, Commander. He's here to evaluate you.
Guess that explains why I bump into him every time I turn around.
The Alliance has been pushing for this for a long time. Humanity wants a larger role in shaping interstellar policy. We want more say with the Citadel Council. The Spectres represent the Council's power and authority. If they accept a human into their ranks, it shows how far the Alliance has come.
You held off an enemy assault during the Blitz single-handed. You showed not only courage, but also incredible skill. That's why I put your name forward as a candidate for the Spectres.
Why would a Turian want a human in the Spectres?
Not all Turians resent humanity. Some of us see the potential of your species. We see what you have to offer to the rest of the galaxy, and to the Spectres. We are an elite group. It's rare to find an individual with the skills we seek. I don't care that you're human, Shepard. I only care that you can do the job.
I assume this is good for the Alliance.
Earth needs this, Shepard. We're counting on you.
I need to see your skills for myself, Commander. Eden Prime will be the first of several missions together.
You'll be in charge of the ground team. Secure the beacon and get it onto the ship ASAP. Nihlus will accompany you to observe the mission.
What do you know about the Protheans?
Just what they taught us in school. They were a technologically advanced species that ruled the galaxy 50,000 years ago. Then they vanished. Nobody really knows how or why, though I've heard plenty of theories. But everyone agrees, galactic civilization wouldn't exist without them.
Their citadel is the very heart of galactic society, and without their mass relays, interstellar travel would be impossible. We all owe the Protheans a great debt.
I'd like to know more about Eden Prime before we touch down.
It's a peaceful farming world, but it represents something much bigger. Eden Prime is one of our oldest and most successful colonies. It proved we were ready to face the challenges of settling new worlds, to forge a place for humanity beyond Earth. It symbolizes humanity's growth and evolution as a spacefaring species. And after this, it will be known as the world where humans made a discovery of galactic importance.
Why is this beacon so important?
All advanced galactic civilization is based on Prothean technology, even yours.
If we hadn't discovered those Prothean ruins buried on Mars, we'd still be stuck on Earth. That was just a small data cache. Who knows what we can learn from this beacon? What if it's a weapons archive? We can't let it fall into the wrong hands.
Like who?
The Attican Traverse isn't the most stable sector of Citadel space. There are plenty of raiders and criminal groups active in the region. They might figure a Prothean beacon is worth the risk of attacking an Alliance ship. Plus, Eden Prime is right on the border of the Terminus systems.
The Attican Traverse is under Citadel protection. If the Terminus systems attack, it's an act of war.
Technically, yes. But some of the species in the Terminus might be willing to start a war over this.
The last thing the Council wants is to get dragged into a major conflict with the Terminus systems. We have to keep this low-key.
Just give the word, Captain.
We should be getting close to Eden.
Captain, we got a problem.
What's wrong, Joker?
Transmission from Eden Prime, sir. You better see this.
Bring it up on screen.
Get down!
I repeat, heavy casualties! We can't stop there! We need evac! They came out of nowhere! We need...
cuts out after that. No comm traffic at all. It just goes dead. There's nothing.
Reverse and hold at 38.5. Status report.
17 minutes out, Captain. No other Alliance ships in the area.
Take us in, Joker. Fast and quiet. This mission just got a lot more complicated.
A small strike team can move quickly, without drawing attention. It's our best chance to secure the beacon.
Grab your gear and meet us in the cargo hold. Tell Alenko and Jenkins to suit up, Commander. You're going in.
Engaging stealth systems. Somebody was doing some serious digging here, Captain.
Your team's the muscle in this operation, Commander. Go in heavy and head straight for the dig site.
What about survivors, Captain?
Helping survivors is a secondary objective. The beacon's your top priority.
Approaching drop point one.
Nihilus, you're coming with us?
I move faster on my own.
Nihilus will scout out ahead. He'll feed you status reports throughout the mission. Otherwise, I want radio silence.
We've got his back, Captain.
The mission's yours now, Shepard. Good luck!
We are approaching drop point two.
We'll see that he receives a proper service once the mission is complete. But I need you to stay focused.
Aye, aye, ma'am.
Gunnery Chief Ashley Williams of the 212. You the one in charge here, ma'am?
Are you wounded, Williams?
A few scrapes and burns. Nothing serious. The others weren't so lucky. Oh, man. We were patrolling the perimeter when the attack hit. We tried to get off a distress call, but they cut off our communications. I've been fighting for my life ever since.
Where's the rest of your squad?
We tried to double back to the beacon, but we walked into an ambush. I don't think any of the others... I think I'm the only one left.
This isn't your fault, Williams. You couldn't have done anything to save them.
Yes, ma'am. We held our position as long as we could, until the Geth overwhelmed us.
The Geth haven't been seen outside the Vale in nearly 200 years. Why are they here now?
They must have come for the beacon. The dig site is close, just over that rise. It might still be there.
We could use your help, Williams.
Aye, aye, ma'am. It's time for payback.
What else do you know about the Geth?
Just what I remember from history class back in school. They're synthetics, non-organic life forms with limited AI programming, created by the Quarians a few centuries ago. They were supposed to be a source of cheap labor, but ended up turning on the Quarians and drove them into exile. Well, after that, they just kind of disappeared behind the Perseus Veil. Nobody's really heard much from them since.
Tell me everything you know about the beacon.
They were doing some digging out here to extend the monorail and expand the colony. A few weeks ago, they unearthed some Prothean ruins, and the beacon. Suddenly, every scientific expert in the colony was interested. That's when they brought us in to secure the site. I don't know much about the beacon itself, but I heard one of the researchers say this could be the biggest scientific discovery of the century.
What happened to the researchers at the dig site?
I don't know. They set up camp near the beacon, The 232 was with them. Maybe their unit fared better than mine.
Describe what happened leading up to the attack.
We were sent out a couple of nights ago from the main colony to secure the area. Seemed like a routine patrol, until the Geth hit us. We never knew they were coming.
Have you seen a Turian Spectre around here?
There aren't any Turians on Eden Prime. None that I've ever met. Not sure I'd be able to tell if one was a Spectre anyway.
If you saw this guy, you'd know. Carries enough firepower to wipe out a whole platoon. Luckily, he's on our side.
Sorry. Like I said, no Turians.
Move out!
This is the dig site. The beacon was right here. It must have been moved.
By who? Our side or the Geth?
Hard to say. Maybe we'll know more after we check out the research camp.
You think anyone got out of here alive?
If they were lucky. Maybe hiding up in the camp. It's just on the top of this ridge, up the ramps. Looks like they hit the camp hard.
It's a good place for an ambush. Keep your guard up. Oh God, they're still alive!
What did the Geth do to them?
Humans, thank the Maker.
Hurry, close the door before they come back.
Don't worry, we'll protect you.
Thank you, I think we'll be okay now. It looks like everyone's gone.
You're Dr. Warren, the one in charge of the excavation. Do you know what happened to the beacon?
It was moved to the spaceport this morning. Manuel and I stayed behind to help pack up the camp. When the attack came, the Marines held them off long enough for us to hide. They gave their lives to save us.
No one is saved. The age of humanity is ended. Soon, only ruin and corpses will remain.
What else can you tell me about the attack?
It all happened so fast. One second we were gathering up our equipment, the next we were hiding in the shed while the Geth swarmed over the camp.
Agents of the Destroyers, bringers of darkness, heralds of our extinction.
We could hear the battle outside, gunfire, screams. I thought it would never end. Then everything went quiet. We just sat there, too afraid to move, until you came along.
Did you notice a Turian in the area?
I saw him, the Prophet, leader of the enemy. He was here before the attack.
That's impossible. Nihlus was with us in the Normandy before the attack. He couldn't have been here.
I'm sorry. Manuel's still a bit unsettled. We haven't seen your Turian. We've been hiding in here since the attack.
Can you tell me anything about the beacon?
It's some type of data module from a galaxy-wide communications network. Remarkably well-preserved. It could be the greatest scientific discovery of our lifetime. Miraculous new technologies, groundbreaking medical advances. Who knows what secrets are locked inside?
We have unearthed the heart of evil. Awakened the beast. Unleashed the darkness.
Manuel, please. This isn't the time.
What's wrong with your assistant?
Manuel has a brilliant mind, but he's always been a bit unstable. Genius and madness are two sides of the same coin.
Is it madness to see the future? To see the destruction rushing towards us? To understand there is no escape? No hope? No. I am not mad. I'm the only sane one left.
I gave him an extra dose of his meds after the attack.
Williams, take us to the spaceport.
You can't stop it. Nobody can stop it. Night is falling. The darkness of eternity.
Hush, Manuel. Go lie down. You'll feel better once the medication kicks in.
Saren. Nihlus. This isn't your mission, Saren. What are you doing here?
The Council thought you could use some help on this one.
I wasn't expecting to find the Geth here. The situation's bad.
Don't worry. I've got it under control.
What is that? Off in the distance.
It's a ship. Look at the size of it.
Nihilus.
Something's moving over behind those crates.
Wait! Don't shoot! I'm one of you! I'm human!
Sneaking up on us like that nearly got you killed.
I'm sorry. I was hiding from those creatures. My name's Powell. I saw what happened to that Turian. The other one shot him.
I need to know how Nihilus died.
The other one got here first. He was waiting when your friend showed up. He called him Saren. I think they knew each other. Your friend seemed to relax. He let his guard down. And Saren killed him. Shot him right in the back. I'm just lucky he didn't see me behind the crates.
We were told a Prothean beacon was brought to the spaceport. What happened to it?
It's over on the other platform, probably where that guy Saren was headed. He hopped on the cargo train right after he killed your friend. I knew that beacon was trouble. Everything's gone to hell since we found it. First that damn mothership showed up, then the attack. They killed everyone. Everyone. If I had men behind the crates, I'd be dead too.
How come you're the only one who survived? Why didn't anyone else try to hide behind the crates?
They never had a chance. I was already behind the crates when the attack started.
Wait a minute. You were hiding behind the crates before the attack?
Sometimes I need a nap to get through my shift. I sneak off behind the crates to grab 40 winks where the supervisor can't find me.
You survived because you're lazy? If you hadn't snuck off for that nap, you'd probably be dead just like all the others.
Yeah. Yeah, I guess. I don't really want to think about it.
Tell me about the Geth attack.
It was quick. 1 minute that ship was descending, the next, those Geth were swarming over the platform, thousands of them. They must have been inside that mothership. They shot anything that moved. It was a massacre.
Is there anything else you can tell me about the beacon?
They brought it here this morning. We loaded it up onto the train and shipped it to the other platform. Hard to believe that was only a few hours ago. Feels like a whole other life.
Tell me about this mothership you saw.
I've never seen anything like it before. It was huge. Landed over near that platform. The whole place got dark as it came down. And it was making this noise, this sound that bored right into your brain. That's what woke me up. The attack came a few minutes later.
We need to find that beacon before it's too late.
Take the cargo train. That's where the other Turian went. I can't stay here. I need to get away from all this.
Set the charges. Destroy the entire colony. Leave no evidence that we were here.
Normandy, the beacon is secure.
This is amazing. Actual working Prothean technology. Unbelievable.
It wasn't doing anything like that when they dug it up.
Something must have activated it.
Roger, Normandy. Standing by. No! Don't touch it! It's too dangerous!
We identified the ship that touched down on Eden Prime, the Normandy, a Human Alliance vessel. It was under the command of Captain Anderson. They managed to save the colony.
And the beacon.
One of the humans may have used it.
Doctor? Dr. Chakwas? I think she's waking up.
You had us worried there, Shepard. How are you feeling?
Minor throbbing. Nothing serious. How long was I out?
About 15 hours. Something happened down there with the beacon, I think.
It's my fault. I must have triggered some kind of security field when I approached it. You had to push me out of the way.
You had no way to know what would happen.
Actually, we don't even know if that's what set it off. Unfortunately, we'll never get the chance to find out.
The beacon exploded. A system overload, maybe. The blast knocked you cold. Williams and I had to carry you back here to the ship.
I appreciate it.
Physically, you're fine. But I detected some unusual brain activity. Abnormal beta waves. I also noticed an increase in your rapid eye movement. Signs typically associated with intense dreaming.
I saw... I'm not sure what I saw. Death, destruction... Nothing's really clear.
I better add this to my report. It may... Oh. Captain Anderson.
How's our XO holding up, Doctor?
Well, all the readings look normal. I'd say the command is going to be fine.
Glad to hear it. Shepard, I need to speak with you. In private.
Aye, aye, Captain. I'll be in the mess if you need me.
Sounds like that beacon hit you pretty hard, Commander. Are you sure you're okay?
I don't like soldiers dying under my command.
Jenkins wasn't your fault. You did a good job, Shepard.
Did we leave Gunnery Chief Williams back on Eden Prime?
I figured we could use a soldier like her. She's been reassigned to the Normandy.
Williams is a good soldier. She deserves it.
Lieutenant Elenko agrees with you. That's why I added her to our crew.
Intel dropped the ball, sir. We had no idea what we were walking into down there. That's why things went to hell.
The Geth haven't been outside the Vale in 2 centuries, Commander. Nobody could have predicted this.
You said you needed to see me in private, Captain?
I won't lie to you, Shepard. Things look bad. Nihlus is dead. The beacon was destroyed and Geth are invading. The Council's going to want answers.
I didn't do anything wrong, Captain. Hopefully the Council can see that.
I'll stand behind you and your report, Shepard. You're a damned hero in my books. That's not why I'm here. It's Saren. That other Turian. Saren's a specter. One of the best. A living legend. But if he's working with the Geth, it means he's gone rogue. A rogue Spectre's trouble. Saren's dangerous. And he hates humans.
Why?
He thinks we're growing too fast, taking over the galaxy. A lot of aliens think that way. Most of them don't do anything about it. But Saren has allied himself with the Geth. I don't know how, I don't know why. I only know it had something to do with that beacon. You were there just before that beacon self-destructed. Did you see anything? Any clue that might tell us what Saren was after?
Just before I lost consciousness, I had some kind of vision.
A vision? A vision of what?
I saw synthetics. Geth, maybe. Slaughtering people. Butchering them.
We need to report this to the Council, Shepard.
What are we gonna tell them? I had a bad dream?
We don't know what information was stored in that beacon. Lost Prothean technology? Blueprints for some ancient weapon of mass destruction? Whatever it was. Saren took it. But I know Saren. I know his reputation, his politics. He believes humans are a blight on the galaxy. This attack was an act of war. He has the secrets from the beacon. He has an army of Geth at his command, and he won't stop until he's wiped humanity from the face of the galaxy.
I'll find some way to take him down.
It's not that easy. He's a Spectre. He can go anywhere, do almost anything. That's why we need the Council on our side.
We prove Saren's gone rogue and the Council will revoke his Spectre status.
I'll contact the Ambassador and see if he can get us an audience with the Council. He'll want to see us as soon as we reach the Citadel. We should be getting close. Head up to the bridge and tell Joker to bring us into dock.
Good timing, Commander. I was just about to bring us into the Citadel. See that taxpayer money at work. Size isn't everything.
Why so touchy, Joker?
I'm just saying, you need firepower, too.
Look at that monster! Its main gun could rip through the barriers in any ship in the Alliance fleet.
Good thing it's on our side, then.
Citadel Control, this is SSV Normandy, requesting permission to land.
Stand by for clearance, Normandy. Clearance granted. You may begin your approach. Transferring you to an Alliance operator.
Roger, Alliance Tower. Normandy out.
Normandy, this is Alliance Tower. Please proceed to Dock 422.
This is an outrage! The Council would step in if the Geth attacked a Turian colony?
The Turians don't found colonies on the borders of the Terminus systems, Ambassador.
Humanity was well aware of the risks when you went into the Traverse.
What about Saren? You can't just ignore a rogue Spectre. I demand action!
You don't get to make demands of the Council, Ambassador.
Citadel Security is investigating your charges against Saren. We will discuss the CSEC findings at the hearing, not before.
Captain Anderson, I see you brought half your crew with you.
Just the ground team from Eden Prime, in case you had any questions.
I have the mission reports. I assume they're accurate?
They are. Sounds like you convinced the Council to give us an audience.
They were not happy about it. Saren's their top agent. They don't like him being accused of treason.
Saren's a threat to every human colony out there. He needs to be stopped. The Council has to listen to us.
Settle down, Commander. You've already done more than enough to jeopardize your candidacy for the Spectres. The mission on Eden Prime was a chance to prove you could get the job done. Instead, Nihilus ended up dead and the beacon was destroyed.
That's Saren's fault, not hers.
Then we better hope the CSEC investigation turns up evidence to support our accusations. Otherwise, the Council might use this as an excuse to keep you out of the Spectres. Come with me, Captain. I want to go over a few things before the hearing. Shepard, you and the others can meet us at the Citadel Tower, top level. I'll make sure you have clearance to get in.
And that's why I hate politicians.
Saren's hiding something. Give me more time. Stall them.
Stall the Council? Don't be ridiculous. Your investigation is over, Garrus.
Commander Shepard, Garrus Vakarian. I was the officer in charge of the CSEC investigation into Saren.
Sounds like you really want to bring him down.
I don't trust him. Something about him rubs me the wrong way. But he's a Spectre. Everything he touches is classified. I can't find any hard evidence.
I think the Council's ready for us, Commander.
Good luck, Shepard. Maybe they'll listen to you.
The hearing's already started. Come on.
The Geth attack is a matter of some concern, but there is nothing to indicate Saren was involved in any way.
V,
The investigation by Citadel Security turned up no evidence to support your charge of treason.
An eyewitness saw him kill Nihlus in cold blood.
We've read the Eden Prime reports, Ambassador. The testimony of one traumatized dock worker is hardly compelling proof.
I resent these accusations. Nihlus was a fellow Spectre and a friend.
That just let you catch him off guard.
Captain Anderson, you always seem to be involved when humanity makes false charges against me. And this must be your protege, Commander Shepard. The one who let the beacon get destroyed.
The mission to Eden Prime was top secret. The only way you could know about the beacon was if you were there.
With Nihlus gone, his files passed on to me. I read the Eden Prime report. I was unimpressed. But what can you expect from a human?
Saren despises humanity. That's why he attacked Eden Prime.
Your species needs to learn its place, Shepard. You're not ready to join the Council. You're not even ready to join the Spectres.
He has no right to say that. That's not his decision.
Shepard's admission into the Spectres is not the purpose of this meeting.
This meeting has no purpose. The humans are wasting your time, Counselor, and mine.
Saren's hiding behind his position as a Spectre. You need to open your eyes.
What we need is evidence. So far, we've seen nothing.
There is still one outstanding issue. Commander Shepard's vision. It may have been triggered by the beacon.
Are we allowing dreams into evidence now? How can I defend my innocence against this kind of testimony?
I agree. Our judgment must be based on facts and evidence, not wild imaginings and reckless speculation.
Do you have anything else to add, Commander Shepard?
You've made your decision. I won't waste my breath.
The Council has found no evidence of any connection between Saren and the Geth. Ambassador, your petition to have him disbarred from the Spectres is denied.
I'm glad to see justice was served.
This meeting is adjourned.
It was a mistake bringing you into that hearing, Captain. You and Saren have too much history. It made the Council question our motives.
I know Saren. He's working with the Geth for one reason. To exterminate the entire human race. Every colony we have is at risk. Every world we control is in danger. Even Earth isn't safe.
Tell me about this history between you and Saren.
I worked with him on a mission a long time ago. Things went bad. Real bad. We shouldn't talk about this here. But I know what he's like, and he has to be stopped.
We need to deal with Saren ourselves.
As a Spectre, he's virtually untouchable. We need to find some way to expose him.
What about Garrus, that CSEC investigator? We saw him arguing with the Executor.
That's right. He was asking for more time to finish his report. Seems like he was close to finding something on Saren.
Any idea where we could find him?
I have a contact in CSEC who can help us track Garrus down. His name is Harkin.
Forget it. They suspended Harkin last month, drinking on the job. I won't waste my time with that loser.
You won't have to. I don't want the Council using your past history with Saren as an excuse to ignore anything we turn up. Shepard will handle this.
You can't just cut Captain Anderson out of this investigation.
The Ambassador's right. I need to step aside.
I need to take care of some business. Captain, meet me in my office later.
Harkin's probably getting drunk at Cora's Den. It's a dingy little club in the lower section of the wards.
Maybe there's another way to find evidence against Saren.
You should talk to Barla Vaughn over in the financial district. Rumor has it he's an agent for the Shadow Broker.
The Shadow Broker?
An information dealer. Buys and sells secrets to the highest bidder. I've heard Barla Vaughn's one of the top representatives. He might know something about Saren, but his information won't come cheap.
Tell me more about the Shadow Broker.
He's a necessary evil of galactic politics. Buying and selling information is a part of the game, and the Shadow Broker just happens to be the best player on the field. Always sells to the highest bidder. Doesn't get involved in politics, doesn't pick sides. A simple system, but it works. He's not a threat to anyone, not directly. He's just a resource we can use, or she is. Or maybe they are. Nobody really knows.
Our ambassador doesn't seem to get along with the Council.
He's just frustrated. The Council's always preaching that we need to be part of the galactic community. But for them, it's a one-way street. They want us to expand and settle unstable regions like the Skillian Verge and the Attican Traverse. But when we run into trouble, they don't want to help us out. Everyone knows it's only a matter of time until we get a seat on the Council. The ambassador just thinks it should happen sooner rather than later. And I agree.
Maybe they'd let us join the Council if we were more willing to cooperate with the other species.
Of course they would. If we did everything they told us to, they'd love to have us on the Council. But it wouldn't be much of a deal for us. I understand their side. They don't want us dominating the Council. It's founded on cooperation and alliances. But we have to look out for our own interests, too.
You don't think much of Harkin.
The guy joined CSEC about 20 years ago. He's been an embarrassment to our species ever since. Roughing up suspects in custody, bribery accusations, alcohol and drug use. The embassy used to step in when he got in trouble. But I guess enough was enough.
Guy's a scumbag. He should have been cut loose a long time ago.
He was one of the first human CSEC officers. Guess it would have looked bad if he got fired. A lot of backroom deals were worked out over the years to keep him on the force. Politics is a dirty business sometimes, but it looks like his time's run out. We've got enough humans in CSEC now to stop protecting him.
I want to know more about the Spectres.
They're not your typical government agency. They tend to work alone, behind the scenes. They take care of problems the Council can't. It's not easy preserving peace across an entire galaxy. The Council prefers to use diplomacy and negotiation. But sometimes more extreme measures are needed.
How do they decide who becomes a Spectre?
You can't just apply to join. There's no training program. Spectres aren't made. They're born. The Council's always looking for exceptional individuals. People who can get the job done, like you. They've been watching you for years. They see something in you. They want you on their side. Nihlus was supposed to give them a final recommendation, but with him gone, things are still up in the air.
They sound like shadow operatives.
Everything about them is classified. We don't even know how many there are. The latest Alliance estimate puts their numbers under 100, but the Council couldn't do its job without them. They're the Citadel's top agents, the last line of defense, the final option before open war. The entire galaxy respects and fears them. If a Spectre shows up, you know something big is about to happen.
What's their command structure like?
There is no command structure. Each Spectre answers directly to the Council. Sometimes they're sent on specific missions. Other times, they act on their own.
They tend to operate outside the law, do whatever it takes to accomplish their goals. The Council just turns a blind eye. Spectres have a lot of power, Shepard.
What happens when a Spectre goes rogue, like Saren?
It doesn't happen often. The Council is careful when they select their candidates. But when something does go wrong, there's usually only one solution. Send another Spectre to bring the rogue agent down.
You and Saren have a history. What happened?
About 20 years ago, I was part of a mission in the Skillian Verge. I was working with Saren to find and remove a known terrorist threat. Saren eliminated his target, but a lot of people died along the way, innocent people. And the official records just covered it all up. But I saw how he operates. No conscience, no hesitation. He'd kill 1,000 innocent civilians to end a war without a second thought.
Killing innocents doesn't end wars. It causes them.
I know how the world works, Commander. Sometimes you're forced to make unpleasant decisions. But only if there's no other way. Saren doesn't even look for another option. He's twisted, broken. He likes the violence, the killing. And he knows how to cover his tracks.
I should go.
Good luck, Shepard. I'll be over in the ambassador's office if you need anything else.
Back off, Rex. Viz told us to take you down if you showed up. What are you waiting for? I'm standing right here. This is Fist's only chance. If he's smart, he'll take it.
He's not coming out, Rex. End of story.
The story is just beginning.
Out of my way, humans. I have no quarrel with you.
What was that all about?
Who knows? Let's just try not to get caught in the middle.
Hey there, sweetheart. You looking for some fun? Because I gotta say, that soldier getup looks real good on that body of yours. Why don't you sit your sweet little ass down beside old Harkin? Have a drink. See where this goes.
Maybe later.
Suit yourself, princess. You know, if more Marines looked like you, I might have joined the Alliance instead of seasick.
Harkin, right? I was told you could help me find someone.
Garrus? You must be one of Captain Anderson's crew. Poor bastard, still trying to bring Saren down, eh? I know where Garrus is, but you gotta tell me something first. Did the captain let you in on his big secret?
Is there something I should know about the captain?
The captain used to be a Spectre. Didn't know that, did you? It was all very hush-hush. The first human ever given that honor. And then he blew it. Screwed up his mission so bad they kicked him out. Of course, he blames Saren. Says the Turians set him up.
Why'd they kick him out?
Have to ask him. I never heard any of the details. Bet it's a good story, though. The heroes fall. Classic tragedy.
You said they covered all this up. How'd you hear about it?
I spent 20 years working cases here on the Citadel. People on this station love to talk. Secrets are like herpes. If you got them, you might as well spread them around.
You're a pig.
Just noticed that now, did you?
Just tell me where Garrus went.
Garrus was sniffing around Dr. Michelle's office. She runs the med clinic on the other side of the wards. Must have heard he was going back there.
I'm out of here.
I didn't tell anyone, I swear!
That was smart, Doc. Now if Garrus comes around, you stay smart. Keep your mouth shut or...
Who are you?
Let her go.
Ah!
Perfect timing, Shepard. Gave me a clear shot at that bastard.
What were you thinking? You could have hit the hostage.
There wasn't time to think. I just reacted. I didn't mean to... Dr. Michelle, are you hurt?
No, I'm okay. Thanks to you. All of you.
I know those men threatened you, but if you tell us who they work for, we can protect you.
They work for Feast. They wanted to shut me up, keep me from telling Garrus about the Quarian.
What Quarian?
A few days ago, a Quarian came by my office. She'd been shot, but she wouldn't tell me who did it. I could tell she was scared, probably on the run. She asked me about the Shadow Broker. She wanted to trade information in exchange for a safe place to hide.
Then what?
I put her in contact with Fist. He's an agent for the Shadow Broker.
Not anymore. Now he works for Saren. And the Shadow Broker isn't too happy about it.
Fist betrayed the Shadow Broker? That's stupid, even for him. Saren must have made him quite the offer.
That Quarian must have something Saren wants. Something worth crossing the Shadow Broker to get.
She must have something that proves he's a traitor. Did the Quarian mention anything about Saren, or the Geth?
She did. The information she was going to trade. She said it had something to do with the Geth.
She must be able to link Saren to the Geth. There's no way the Council can ignore this.
Time we paid Fist a visit.
This is your show, Shepard. But I want to bring Saren down as much as you do. I'm coming with you.
You're a Turian. Why do you want to bring him down?
I couldn't find the proof I needed in my investigation, but I knew what was really going on. Saren is a traitor to the Council and a disgrace to my people.
Welcome aboard, Garrus.
You know, we aren't the only ones going after Fist. The Shadow Broker hired a Krogan bounty hunter named Rex to take him out.
Yeah, we saw him in the bar.
A Krogan might come in handy.
Last I heard, he was at the CSEC Academy.
What's he doing there?
Fist accused him of making threats. We brought Rex in for a little talk. If you hurry, you can catch him at the Academy before he leaves.
Move out.
Witnesses saw you making threats in Fist's bar. Stay away from him.
I don't take orders from you.
This is your only warning, Rex.
You should warn Fist. I will kill him.
You want me to arrest you?
I want you to try.
Go on. Get out of here.
Do I know you, human?
My name's Shepard. I'm going after Fist. Thought you might want to come along.
Shepard. Commander Shepard. I've heard a lot about you. We're both warriors, Shepard. Out of respect, I'll give you fair warning. I'm going to kill Fist.
Fist knows you're coming. We'll have a better chance if we all work together.
My people have a saying. Seek the enemy of your enemy, and you will find a friend.
Glad to have you on the team, Rex.
Let's go. I hate to keep Fist waiting.
Stop right there! Don't come any closer!
Warehouse workers. All the real guards must be dead.
Stay back, or we'll shoot!
This would be a good time to find somewhere else to work.
Yeah, right. That's a good idea.
Yeah, I never liked Fist anyway.
I would have never thought of that.
Shooting people isn't always the answer.
Wait! Don't kill me! I surrender!
Where's the Quarian?
She's not here. I don't know where she is. That's the truth.
He's lying.
You better start explaining before I lose my temper.
The Quarian isn't here. Said she'd only deal with the Shadow Broker himself.
Impossible. The Shadow Broker only works through his agents.
Nobody meets the Shadow Broker. Ever. Even I don't know his true identity. But she didn't know that. I told her I'd set a meeting up. But when she shows up, it'll be Saren's men waiting for her.
Give me the location. Now.
Here on the wards, the back alley by the markets. She's supposed to meet them right now. You can make it if you hurry.
I never want to see you again. Is that clear?
Don't worry, you'll never see me again.
Did you bring it?
Where's the Shadow Broker? Where's Fist?
They'll be here. Where's the evidence?
No way. The deal's off. Fist set me up. I knew I couldn't trust him.
Were you hurt in the fight?
I know how to look after myself. Not that I don't appreciate the help. Who are you?
My name's Shepard. I'm looking for evidence to prove Saren's a traitor.
Then I have a chance to repay you for saving my life. But not here. We need to go somewhere safe.
The ambassador's office. It's safe there. You'll want to see this anyway.
You're not making my life easy, Shepard. Firefights in the wards, an all-out assault on Korra's den. Do you know how many... Who's this? A Quarian? What are you up to, Shepard?
Making your day, Ambassador. She has information linking Saren to the Geth.
Really? Maybe you better start at the beginning, miss.
My name is Tali. Tali Zora Naraya.
We don't see many Quarians here. Why did you leave the flotilla?
I was on my pilgrimage. My rite of passage into adulthood.
I've never heard of this before.
It is a tradition among my people. When we reach maturity, we leave the ships of our parents and our people behind. Alone, we search the stars, only returning to the flotilla once we have discovered something of value. In this way, we prove ourselves worthy of adulthood.
What kinds of things do you look for?
It could be resources like food or fuel, or some type of useful technology, or even knowledge that will make life easier on the flotilla. Through our pilgrimage, we prove that we will contribute to the community, rather than being a burden on our limited resources.
Tell us what you found.
During my travels, I began hearing reports of Geth. Since they drove my people into exile, the Geth have never ventured beyond the Vale. I was curious. I tracked a patrol of Geth to an uncharted world. I waited for one to become separated from its unit. Then I disabled it and removed its memory core.
I thought the Geth fried their memory cores when they died. Some kind of defense mechanism.
How did you manage to preserve the memory core?
My people created the Geth. If you're quick, careful, and lucky, small caches of data can sometimes be saved. Most of the core was wiped clean, but I salvaged something from its audio banks.
Eden Prime was a major victory. The beacon has brought us one step closer to finding the conduit.
That's Saren's voice. This proves he was involved in the attack.
Saren won't get out of this one.
Wait, there's more. Saren wasn't working alone.
Eden Prime was a major victory. The beacon has brought us one step closer to finding the conduit.
And one step closer to the return of the Reapers.
I don't recognize that other voice, the one talking about Reapers.
I feel like I've heard that name before.
According to the Memory Core, the Reapers were a hyper-advanced machine race that existed 50,000 years ago. The Reapers hunted the Protheans to total extinction, and then they vanished. At least, that's what the Geth believe.
Sounds a little far-fetched.
The vision on Eden Prime. I understand it now. I saw the Protheans being wiped out by the Reapers.
The Geth revere the Reapers as gods, the pinnacle of non-organic life. And they believe Saren knows how to bring the Reapers back.
The Council is just going to love this.
The Reapers are a threat to every species in Citadel space. We have to tell them.
No matter what they think about the rest of this, those audio files prove Saren's a traitor.
The Captain's right. We need to present this to the Council right away.
What about her, the Quarian?
My name is Tali. You saw me in the alley, Commander. You know what I can do. Let me come with you.
I thought you were on your pilgrimage.
The pilgrimage proves we are willing to give of ourselves for the greater good. What does it say about me if I turn my back on this? Saren is a danger to the entire galaxy. My pilgrimage can wait.
I'll take all the help I can get.
Thanks. You won't regret this.
Anderson and I will go ahead to get things ready with the Council. Take a few minutes to collect yourself, then meet us in the tower.
Come on. Udina's presenting the Quarian's evidence to the Council.
Eden Prime was a major victory. The beacon has brought us one step closer to finding the conduit.
And one step closer to the return of the Reapers.
You wanted proof? There it is.
This evidence is irrefutable, Ambassador. Saren will be stripped of his Spectre status, and all efforts will be made to bring him in to answer for his crimes.
I recognize the other voice, the one speaking with Saren. Matriarch Benezia.
She must be working with the Geth, too.
Matriarch Benezia is a powerful biotic, and she had many followers. She will make a formidable ally for Saren.
I'm more interested in the Reapers. What do you know about them?
Only what was extracted from the Geth's memory core. The Reapers were an ancient race of machines that wiped out the Protheans. Then they vanished.
The Geth believe the Reapers are gods, and Saren is the prophet for their return.
We think the conduit is the key to bringing them back. Saren's searching for it. That's why he attacked Eden Prime.
Do we even know what this conduit is?
Saren thinks it can bring back the Reapers. That's bad enough.
Listen to what you're saying. Saren wants to bring back the machines that wiped out all life in the galaxy? Impossible. It has to be. Where did the Reapers go? Why did they vanish? How come we found no trace of their existence? If they were real, we'd have found something.
I tried to warn you about Saren and you refused to face the truth. Don't make the same mistake again.
This is different. You proved Saren betrayed the Council. We all agree he's using the Geth to search for the conduit, but we don't really know why.
The Reapers are obviously just a myth, Commander. A convenient lie to cover Saren's true purpose. A legend he is using to bend the Geth to his will.
50,000 years ago, the Reapers wiped out all galactic civilization. If Saren finds the conduit, it will happen again.
Saren is a rogue agent on the run for his life. He no longer has the rights or resources of a Spectre. The Council has stripped him of his position.
That is not good enough. You know he's hiding somewhere in the Traverse. Send your fleet in!
A fleet cannot track down one man.
A Citadel fleet could secure the entire region, keep the Geth from attacking any more of our colonies.
Or it could trigger a war with the Terminus systems. We won't be dragged into a galactic confrontation over a few dozen human colonies.
Every time humanity asks for help, you ignore us.
Shepard's right. I'm sick of this council and its anti-human bull...
Ambassador, there is another solution. A way to stop Saren that does not require fleets or armies.
No, it's too soon. Humanity is not ready for the responsibilities that come with joining the Spectres.
You don't have to send a fleet into the Traverse, and the Ambassador gets his human Spectre. Everybody's happy.
Commander Shepard, step forward. It is the decision of the Council that you be granted all the powers and privileges of the Special Tactics and Reconnaissance Branch of the Citadel.
Spectres are not trained, but chosen. Individuals forged in the fire of service and battle. Those whose actions elevate them above the rank and file.
Spectres are an ideal, a symbol, the embodiment of courage, determination, and self-reliance. They are the right hand of the Council, instruments of our will.
Spectres bear a great burden. They are protectors of galactic peace, both our first and last line of defense. The safety of the galaxy is theirs to uphold.
You are the first human Spectre, Commander. This is a great accomplishment for you and your entire species.
I'm honored, Counselor.
We're sending you into the Traverse after Saren. He's a fugitive from justice, so you are authorized to use any means necessary to apprehend or eliminate him.
I'll find him.
This meeting of the Council is adjourned.
Congratulations, Commander.
We've got a lot of work to do, Shepard. You're going to need a ship, a crew, supplies.
You'll get access to special equipment and training now. You should go down to the CSEC Academy and speak to the Spectre Requisitions Officer.
Anderson, come with me. I'll need your help to set all this up.
I expected your ambassador to be more grateful. He didn't even thank you.
Until I find Saren, I haven't done anything. Come on.
Right behind you, Commander.
I've got big news for you, Shepard. Captain Anderson is stepping down as commanding officer of the Normandy. The ship is yours now.
She's quick and quiet, and you know the crew. Perfect ship for a Spectre. Treat her well, Commander.
I'll take good care of her, sir.
I know you will, Commander.
I want the truth. Why are you stepping down, sir?
You needed your own ship. A Spectre can't answer to anyone but the Council. And it's time for me to step down.
Come clean with me, Captain. You owe me that much.
I was in your shoes 20 years ago, Shepard. They were considering me for the Spectres.
Why didn't you ever mention this?
What was I supposed to say? I could have been a Spectre, but I blew it? I failed, Commander. It's not something I'm proud of. Ask me later and I'll tell you the whole story. For now, all you need to know is, I was sent on a mission with Saren, and he made sure the Council rejected me. I had my shot. It came and went. Now you have a chance to make up for my mistakes.
I won't let you down, sir.
Saren's gone. Don't even try to find him. But we know what he's after. The Conduit. He's got his Geth scouring the Traverse looking for clues.
We had reports of Geth in the Pharos system shortly before our colony there dropped out of contact. And there have been sightings around Novaria.
Find out what Saren was after on Pharos and Novaria. Maybe you can figure out where the Conduit is before he does.
Anything else?
We have one more lead. Matriarch Benezia, the other voice in that recording. She has a daughter, a scientist who specializes in the Protheans. We don't know if she's involved, but it might be a good idea to try and find her. See what she knows. Her name's Liara, Dr. Liara Tassoni. We have reports she was exploring an archaeological dig on one of the uncharted worlds in the Artemis Tau cluster.
The colonists on Pharos might still be alive.
It's your decision, Commander. You're a Spectre now. You don't answer to us.
But your actions still reflect on humanity as a whole. You make a mess and I get stuck cleaning it up.
I'll try not to make things any harder on you, Ambassador.
Glad to hear it, Commander. Remember, you were a human long before you were a Spectre. I have a meeting to get to. Captain Anderson can answer any questions you might have.
Yes, Commander?
How are you holding up?
Honestly, this isn't how I pictured my career coming to an end. Pushing papers really isn't my thing, but you're the one who can stop Saren. I believe in you, Shepard. If that means I have to step aside, so be it.
Tell me what happened with you and Saren 20 years ago.
It's close to 20 years ago now. Ambassador Goyle was our representative here on the Citadel. Like Udina, she wanted to get a human into the Spectres. She chose me. The Council sent Saren to keep an eye on me and evaluate my performance, just like they sent Nihlus to keep tabs on you.
Why weren't you honest with me?
It's not something I'm proud of. I had a chance to become the first human Spectre, and I failed. Saren made sure of that.
I think I deserve the whole story.
We had intel on a rogue scientist being funded by Batarian interests. He was trying to set up a facility to develop illegal AI technology out in the Verge. Alliance intel had done all the work, but the Council wanted a Spectre involved. We compromised. I was assigned to help Saren in his investigation. We tracked the scientist to a refining facility on Kamala. He was hidden away somewhere inside, protected by an army of Batarian mercenaries. The plan was simple. Sneak into the plant, capture the scientist, sneak back out. Quick, quiet, and a minimum of bloodshed.
I'm guessing things didn't go as planned?
Saren and I split up to cover more ground. Then about halfway through the mission, there was a massive explosion in the refinery core. Officially, it was ruled an accident, but I think Saren detonated it on purpose to draw off the enemy guards.
How many casualties?
The explosion tore the refinery to shreds. The whole place was on fire. Black chemical clouds poured out into the atmosphere. Nobody inside survived. There was a camp for the workers and their families nearby. Between the fires and the toxic fumes, the final death count was over 500. Mostly civilians. Saren didn't care. The target was eliminated. Mission accomplished. And I ended up taking the blame. That ended all talk of me joining the Spectres.
Saren caused the explosion. How'd he pin it on you?
In his report, Saren accused me of blowing his cover. He said it was my fault the guards were ready for us. He claimed that's why it turned into a massacre. Saren's report was all the proof the Council needed to kill my chances of becoming a Spectre.
Don't blame yourself, Captain.
I don't. I blame Saren. I think he wanted things to go bad. He was looking for an excuse to blow that refinery. Maybe he just likes the violence. Maybe he was just trying to make me look bad to keep humans out of the Spectres. If so, he pulled it off.
Why'd you let him get away with it?
Who do you think the Council was going to listen to? Me? Or their best agent? I had a bad feeling about him right from the start. I should have been more careful. Maybe I could have stopped things before they got out of hand.
The only thing I care about is stopping Saren.
You're right, Commander. It's no good living in the past.
Any extra intel you can give me on our colony at Pharos?
The entire planet used to be one giant Prothean city. Mostly ruins now. But some of the infrastructure is still intact. The colony tried to build on what the Protheans left behind. We lost all contact with them when the Geth attacked.
What do you know about the Artemis Tau cluster?
Not much. I've never been there myself. A handful of systems with a few small, uncharted worlds, but no real colonies. Might not be easy finding Dr. Tassoni out there. My advice is to look for the world with the Prothean ruins.
What can you tell me about Novaria?
Novaria's trouble. Always has been. The whole planet's basically a center for corporations to conduct illegal research. Watch your back there, Shepard. Spectres are about the only form of Citadel authority Novaria respects. But they aren't popular.
I should go.
I'll be here if you need anything.
I heard what happened to Captain Anderson. Survives 100 battles and then gets taken down by backroom politics. Just watch your back, Commander. Things go bad on this mission, you're next on their chopping block.
Captain Anderson should be the one in charge. It's like I'm stealing the ship from him.
Yeah, the captain got screwed. But it's not like you could have stopped it. Nobody's blaming you. Everyone on this ship's behind you, Commander. 100%. Intercom's open. You got anything you want to say to the crew? Now's the time.
This is Commander Shepard speaking.
We have our orders. Find Saren before he finds the conduit. I won't lie to you, crew. This mission isn't going to be easy.
For too long, our species has stood apart from the others.
Now it's time for us to step up and do our part for the rest of the galaxy. Time to show them what humans are made of.
Our enemy knows we're coming.
When we go into the Traverse, Saren's followers will be waiting for us. But we'll be ready for them, too.
Humanity needs to do this.
Not just for our own sake, but for the sake of every other species in Citadel space. Saren must be stopped, and I promise you all, we will stop him.
Well said, Commander. Captain will be proud.
The Captain gave up everything so I could have this chance. We can't fail.
Yes, ma'am.
Picking up some strange readings. Really strange, like off the damn charts. It looks like it's coming from an underground complex a few clicks away from the drop zone.
Hello? Could somebody help me? Please? Can you hear me out there? I'm trapped, I need help!
Are you okay? What happened to you?
Listen, this thing I'm in is a Prothean security device. I cannot move, so I need you to get me out of it, all right?
Your mother is working with Saren. Whose side are you on?
What? I am not on anybody's side. I may be Benezia's daughter, but I'm nothing like her. I have not spoken to her in years. Please, just get me out of here.
How did you end up in there?
I was exploring the ruins when the Geth showed up, so I hid in here. Can you believe that? Geth beyond the veil! I activated the tower's defenses. I knew the barrier curtains would keep them out. When I turned it on, I must have hit something I wasn't supposed to. I was trapped in here. You must get me out, please!
We'll find some way to help you.
There is a control in here that should deactivate this thing. You'll have to find some way past the barrier curtain. That's the tricky part. The defenses cannot be shut off from the outside. I don't know how you'll get in here. Be careful. There is a Krogan with the Geth. They have been trying different ways to get past the barrier.
Oh, how did you get in here? I didn't think there was any way past the barrier.
We have to get you out of here before more Geth arrive.
Yes, you're right. I've seen enough of them to last a lifetime. That button should shut down my containment field.
Any idea how we get out of this place?
There is an elevator back in the center of the tower. At least I think it's an elevator. It should take us out of here. Come on! I still cannot believe all this. Why would the Geth come after me? Do you think Benezia's involved?
Saren's looking for the conduit. You're a Prothean expert. He probably wants you to help him find it.
The conduit? But I don't know...
What the hell was that?
These ruins are not stable. That mining laser must have triggered a seismic event. We have to hurry. The whole place is caving in.
Joker, get the Normandy airborne and lock in on my signal. On the double, mister!
Aye, aye, Commander. Secure and away. ETA 8 minutes.
He needs to move faster.
In case you didn't notice, this place is falling apart.
Exhilarating, isn't it? Thanks for getting rid of those energy fields for us. Had the doctor over.
Whatever it is you want, you are not getting it from me.
She'll stay with us, thanks.
Not an option. Saren wants her, and he always gets what he wants. Kill him. Spare the Asari if you can. Not, doesn't matter.
Close, Commander. 10 more seconds, we would have been swimming in molten sulfur. The Normandy isn't equipped to land in exploding volcanoes. They tend to fry our sensors and melt our hull. Just for future reference.
We almost died out there, and your pilot is making jokes?
Joker pulled our asses out of there. I think he's earned the right to a few bad jokes.
I see. It must be a human thing. I don't have a lot of experience dealing with your species, Commander. But I am grateful to you. You saved my life back there, and not just from the volcano. Those Geth would have killed me or dragged me off to Saren.
What did Saren want with you? Do you know something about the conduit?
Only that it was somehow connected to the Prothean extinction. That is my real area of expertise. I have spent the past 50 years trying to figure out what happened to them.
Just how old are you exactly?
I hate to admit it, but I am only 106.
Damn! I hope I look that good when I'm your age.
A century may seem like a long time to a short-lived species like yours, but among the Asari, I am barely considered more than a child. That is why my research has not received the attention it deserves. Because of my youth, other Asari scholars tend to dismiss my theories on what happened to the Protheans.
I've got my own theory on why the Protheans disappeared.
With all due respect, Commander, I have heard every theory out there. The problem is finding evidence to support them. The Protheans left remarkably little behind. It is almost as if someone did not want the mystery solved. It is like someone came along after the Protheans were gone and cleansed the galaxy of clues. But here is the incredible part. According to my findings, the Protheans were not the first galactic civilization to mysteriously vanish. This cycle began long before them.
Where'd you come up with this theory? I thought there wasn't any evidence.
I have been working on this for 50 years. I have tracked down every scrap and shred of evidence. Eventually, subtle patterns start to emerge, patterns that hint at the truth. It is difficult to explain to someone else. I cannot point to one specific thing to prove my case. It is more a feeling derived from a half century of dedicated research. But I know I'm right, and eventually I will be able to prove it. There were other civilizations before the Protheans. This cycle has repeated itself many times over.
If the Protheans weren't the first, then who was?
I don't know. There is barely any evidence on the Protheans, even less on those who came before them. I cannot prove my theory, but I know I am right. The galaxy is built on a cycle of extinction. Each time a great civilization rises up, it is suddenly and violently cast down. Only ruins survive. The Protheans rose up from a single world until their empire spanned the entire galaxy. Yet even they climbed to the top on the remains of those who came before. Their greatest achievements, the mass relays and the Citadel, are based on the technology of those who came before them. And then, like all the other forgotten civilizations throughout galactic history, the Protheans disappeared. I have dedicated my life to figuring out why.
They were wiped out by a race of sentient machines, the Reapers.
The Reapers? But I have never heard of... How do you know this? What evidence do you have?
There was a damaged Prothean beacon on Eden Prime. It burned a vision into my brain. I'm still trying to sort out what it all means.
Visions? Yes, that makes sense. The beacons were designed to transmit information directly into the mind of the user. Finding one that still works is extremely rare. No wonder the Geth attacked Eden Prime. The chance to acquire a working beacon, even a badly damaged one, is worth almost any risk. But the beacons were only programmed to interact with Prothean physiology. Whatever information you received would have been confused, unclear. I am amazed you were able to make sense of it at all. A lesser mind would have been utterly destroyed by the process. You must be remarkably strong-willed, Commander.
This isn't helping us find Saren, or the Conduit.
Of course, you're right. I am sorry, my scientific curiosity got the better of me. Unfortunately, I do not have any information that could help you find the Conduit, or Saren.
I don't know why Saren wanted you out of the picture, but I think we'll be a lot better off if we bring you along.
Thank you, Commander. Saren might come after me again. I cannot think of anywhere safer than here on your ship. And my knowledge of the Protheans might be useful later on.
And her biotics will come in handy when the fighting starts.
Good to have you on the team, Liara.
Thank you, Commander. I am very grateful. Oh, I am afraid I am feeling a bit lightheaded.
When was the last time you ate or slept? Dr. Chakwa should take a look at you.
It is probably just mental exhaustion, coupled with the shock of discovering the Protheans' true fate. I need some time to process all this. Still, it could not hurt to be examined by a medical professional. It will give me the chance to think things over. Are we finished here, Commander?
We can talk again after you've seen the doctor. The rest of you, dismissed.
Mission reports are filed, Commander. You want me to patch you through to the Council?
Patch him through, Joker.
Setting up the link now, Commander.
Received your report, Commander. I understand Dr. Tassoni is on the Normandy.
I assume you're taking the necessary security precautions.
Liara's on our side. The Geth were trying to kill her.
Benezia would never allow Saren to kill her daughter.
Maybe she doesn't know.
Or maybe we don't know her. We never expected she could become a traitor.
At least the mission was a success.
Apart from the utter destruction of a major Prothean ruin. Was that really necessary, Shepard?
The Geth were crawling all over those ruins. We were lucky to make it out alive.
Of course, Commander. The mission must always take priority.
Good luck, Commander. Remember, we are all counting on you.
Approach Control, this is the SSV Normandy, requesting a vector and a berth.
Normandy, your arrival was not scheduled. Our defense grid is armed and tracking you. State your business.
Citadel business. We got a Council Spectre aboard.
Landing access granted, Normandy. Be advised, we will be confirming identification on arrival. If confirmation cannot be established, your vessel will be impounded.
What a fun bunch. I think I'll take my next leave here.
That's far enough.
We're not here to cause problems.
This is an unscheduled arrival. I need your credentials.
You first.
We're the law here. Show some respect.
I'm Captain Maiko Matsuo, Ilanis Risk Control Services.
I'm a Spectre. My name is Shepard.
Load of horse crap, ma'am.
We will need to confirm that. Also, I must advise you that firearms are not permitted on Novaria. Sergeant Sterling, secure their weapons.
We can let them do this, Commander.
Stand down. Their house, their rules.
I'll be behind you. That armor's in good condition.
Captain Matsuo, stand down! We confirmed their identity. Spectres are authorized to carry weapons here, Captain.
You may proceed, Spectre. I hope the rest of your visit will be less confrontational. Parasini-san will meet you upstairs.
Behave yourself.
I am Gianna Parasini, assistant to Administrator Analeas. We apologize for the incident in the docking bay.
I appreciate your help.
You're welcome. You understand our security chief was only doing her job. One of my duties is orientation of new arrivals. Do you have any questions?
Pretty heavy security for such a small port.
The executive board does everything in its power to protect the privacy of our client corporations.
I can't have my investigation hampered.
Tread lightly. The board can bury you in litigation. You'd need an Asari lawyer to see the case through.
Has anyone unusual passed through here recently?
Unusual? An Asari matriarch passed through a few days ago. Lady Benezia.
Saren's right hand? She's here?
Can I speak with her?
Benezia left for the Peak 15 research complex days ago. To the best of my knowledge, she's still there.
Could you tell me how to get there?
You'll need to ask Administrator Analeas for clearance to leave this port.
Where can I find the Administrator?
His office is on the main level, left at the top of the elevator.
Understood. Can we go in now?
Of course. If you need any help, you can ask me at the Administrator's office.
Commander, maybe we should tell Liara that her mother's here, or bring her along. Maybe she can reason with Benezia.
How can I help you?
I'd like to speak to Analeas.
One moment, please. Mr. Analeas?
Yes, what?
Commander Shepard is asking to see you, sir.
Right, fine, come in. You will excuse me if I don't stand up. I have no time to entertain space-born vagabonds.
I'm here as a specter, not a human. Keep that in mind.
Believe me, that is foremost in my mind. This greeting is a courtesy. I will only cooperate as required by the Executive Board. Businesses come here to avoid the second-guessing of galactic law.
I'm conducting an investigation. It's a matter of galactic security.
Yes, isn't everything? I will not allow you to harass our clients. This world is private property.
Do you do business with Saren?
Agent Saren? One of your Spectre compatriots? He is a major investor in Binary Helix Corporation, which is one of Novaria's backers.
Is Binary Helix developing weapons for him?
It's possible, given his interests. What our clients do in their labs is their business.
I've heard an Asari matriarch is here. Benezia?
She arrived a few days ago, accompanied by a personal escort and some cargo. She's up at Peak 15.
What can you tell me about her cargo?
Large, heavy, and sealed. It passed weapon screening. Beyond that, it is not our concern.
What brought her out here?
If I knew, I wouldn't be at liberty to say. She came here as Agent Saren's executor. She is here on business for Binary Helix. There were issues at Peak 15 that required Saren's attention.
What did you mean by personal escort?
The phrase is self-explanatory. Bodyguards attending to the safety of her person, mainly Asari commandos.
Commandos? Odd that you shouldn't mind their presence.
They followed all our regulations. I had no reason to forbid Lady Benezia from taking them.
I'd like to see her. Immediately.
I'm afraid that you cannot. Peak 15 is a private facility in the Skadi Mountains. Regardless, there is a blizzard in the area. Shuttles are grounded and surface access has been cut off.
Back to my other questions.
Every minute of my time you waste costs the company 12 credits. I will keep a running tally.
I have no more questions at this time.
Good. I received a dozen urgent messages while you dithered about.
Afternoon. Sit down, have a drink. What can I do for you?
Are you Lorik Keen? I heard you might be able to help me.
You are the Spectre that just arrived, are you not? What can an old Turian like me possibly help you with?
I'm trying to find a way into the garage. Places to go.
You need a pass. How fortuitous. I'm the manager of the local Synthetic Insights office, for the moment at least. Mr. Analeas closed my office. He claims to be investigating reports of my corruption. The administrator is an interesting man. He's become quite wealthy since he took direct control of rents.
I sense a connection there.
Indeed. I acquired evidence of Analeas's actions. His hired goons are ransacking my office to find it. I suspect your goal lies outside this port. Mr. Analeas would be disinclined to let you wander. If you recover the evidence from my office, I will give you my garage pass, as well as a sum of credits.
Why didn't Analeas cancel your pass clearance?
Why should he? There's nothing outside but snow and hungry Nathak.
How did you get a pass?
I'm a manager. Most executives on Novaria are free to come and go as they will.
You have a plan?
I do. However, there is one other... What is that charming human expression? Fly in the lotion? Violence against Mr. Analeas's thugs may be necessary. He has members of Han Shan's security team searching my offices. He's paying them under the table. Miss Matsuo is unaware of their outside employment.
I'll focus on trying to get your evidence. If I'm lucky, I won't have to fight anyone.
Excellent. Here is my pass into our offices. It will activate the elevator. The evidence is on my office computer. This OSD contains an encryption key to access it. Slide it into the drive and it will auto-execute. Oh, and do try to keep bloodstains off the carpets, would you?
Freeze! Han Shan Security. This office is sealed.
Lorik Keen gave me a pass in.
Keen? Are you working for him? He's under investigation.
Anelaus is paying you to shake this place down. Does Captain Matsuo know you're here?
Hey, I'm not the one who wants Keen. Anelaus has a Varen up his ass about this guy. How about this? You pretend you didn't see us, we'll pretend we didn't see you.
I don't think you're supposed to be in here, Shepard.
You have me at a disadvantage, Miss...
Oh, now you're gonna show some respect? I'm Sergeant Kyra Sterling, Ilanis Risk Control Services. Anelaus would throw you off-world for what you did here. I won't. You know what we did to cop killers on my world?
Being a cop doesn't give you the right to break the law yourself. You accepted bribe money.
I didn't want to fight them. They fired first.
Allow me to reintroduce myself. Parasini, Noveria Internal Affairs.
Why is an internal affairs agent here?
The executive board knows about Anelaus's corruption. I've been undercover for 6 months. I want you to convince Keen to testify before the board. With his evidence, this planet can run profitably again.
You work for Anelaus. Can't you just take his records?
He's a crook, not a moron. He doesn't keep logs on his computer saying, this month I stole 3 million credits. Keen's testimony and records are everything I need to prove Anelaus's guilt in one package.
Why don't you ask Keen directly?
I'm Anelaus's secretary. You'd think he'd believe me? That he'd meet me in some dark alley with his evidence?
I thought corruption was the rule on Noveria.
The rule is, don't rock the boat. Self-interest is tolerated if it doesn't interfere with business. Anelaus is driving customers away.
I need Keen's garage pass to complete my mission.
You help my investigation, I'll provide whatever you need. Favor for a favor.
Seems we'd help more people if we did as she asks.
Look, Shepard, I don't like this either. You Spectres play fast and loose with the law. That's bad for business.
All right. I'll talk to Keen and see if I can convince him.
Thank you. You know where I work. Come talk to me once you know if he'll play ball.
Always a pleasure, Spectre. Any news on that matter I asked you to look into?
I finished the job, but an internal affairs investigator contacted me. She wants you to testify against Anelaus.
Now that you have my property, you want to dictate how I use it? I have no interest in a public spectacle.
Everyone on this station is chafing under Anelaus's extortion. You might end up a hero.
My employers rely on the goodwill of the executive board to work here.
The board was already investigating Anelaus. They're concerned about the worm and their own fruit.
All right. It is obvious that I cannot dissuade you. Very well. I will testify. Make whatever arrangements you need with your contact. I will wait here.
Spectre, have you given any more consideration to my offer?
It took some persuasion, but Keen has agreed to testify.
That's a world of stress off my back. I'll take the evidence for safe transport. I didn't think you'd help me, being a Spectre and all. I guess some of you can be all right.
Doesn't this help you? You don't seem particularly happy.
I'm ecstatic, but right now, I just feel like a long day of work is ending. While you were working on Keen, I got you a garage pass. Be careful up there. I have an arrest to make. Wish I had time to change into something easy to move in. I hate skirts.
This is an outrage. I'll see that you never work in this sector again.
Yeah, get a move on.
You, Shepard! I demand you place this bitch under arrest!
You have the right to remain silent. I wish to God you'd exercise it. See you around the galaxy, Commander. I owe you a beer.
You do not know the privilege of being a mother. There is power in creation. To shape a life, turn it toward happiness or despair. Her children were to be ours, raised to hunt and slay Saren's enemies. Have you faced an Asari commando unit before? Few humans have.
We don't have to fight. You can return to the Citadel with us.
I think not. This is not over. Saren is unstoppable. My mind is filled with his light. Everything is clear.
The Rachni didn't cooperate with you. Why should I?
I will not betray him. You will... You must listen. Saren still whispers in my mind. I can fight his compulsions briefly, but the indoctrination is strong.
So you could turn on me again?
Yes, but it would not be my will, Shepard. People are not themselves around Saren. You come to idolize him, worship him. You would do anything for him. The key is Sovereign, his flagship. It is a dreadnought of incredible size, and its power is extraordinary.
Sovereign's not like other ships. Where did it come from?
I cannot say. The Geth did not build it. Its technology is far more advanced than that of any known species. The longer you stay aboard, the more Saren's will seems correct. You sit at his feet and smile as his words pour into you. It is subtle at first. I thought I was strong enough to resist. Instead, I became a willing tool, eager to serve. He sent me here to find the location of the Mew Relay. Its position was lost thousands of years ago.
How does something that big go missing?
4,000 years ago, a star nearby went supernova. The shockwave propelled the relay out of its system, but did not damage it. Its precise vector and speed are impossible to determine. As millennia passed, the nebula created by the nova enveloped the relay. It is difficult to find any cold object in interstellar space, particularly something swathed in hot dust and radiation.
Someone on Novaria found it?
2,000 years ago, the Rachni inhabited that region of our galaxy. They discovered the relay. The Rachni can share memories across generations. Queens inherit the knowledge of their mothers. I took the location of the relay from the queen's mind. I was not gentle.
How did the Rachni find it?
They searched, patiently. They are territorial creatures, driven to close any possible way into their systems.
Why does Saren need the new relay?
He believes it will lead him to the conduit. I would tell you more if I could, but Saren did not share his counsel with me. I was merely a servant to his cause.
You can still make it right. Give me the information.
I was not myself, but I should have been stronger. I transcribed the data to an OSD. Take it, please.
Knowing the relay's coordinates isn't enough. We need to know where to go from there.
Saren wouldn't tell me his destination. But you must find out quickly. I transmitted the coordinates to him before you arrived. You have to stop me. I can't. His teeth are at my ear. Fingers on my spine. You should. Die. I cannot go on. You will have to stop him, Shepard.
Hold on. We've got Metagel. Maybe we can...
No. He is still in my mind. I am not entirely myself. I never will be again. No light. They always said there would be a...
This one serves as our voice. We cannot sing. Not in these low spaces. Your musics are colorless.
Musics? What?
Your way of communicating is strange, flat. It does not color the air. When we speak, one moves all. We are the mother. We sing for those left behind. The children you thought silenced. We are Rachni.
How are you speaking through her?
Our kind sing through touchings of thought. We pluck the strings, and the other understands. She is weak to urging. She has colors we have no names for. But she is ending. Her music is bittersweet. It is beautiful. The children we birthed were stolen from us before they could learn to sing. They are lost to silence. End their suffering. They cannot be saved. They will only cause harm as they are.
I don't understand. Why are your children killing people?
These needle men. They stole our eggs from us. They sought to turn our children into beasts of war. Claws with no songs of their own. Our elders are comfortable with silence. Children know only fear if no one sings to them. Fear has shattered their minds.
Makes sense. A baby left alone in a closet until he's 16 won't be sane.
If you're sure they can't be saved.
It is lamentable, but necessary. Do what you must. Before you deal with our children, we stand before you. What will you sing? Will you release us? Are we to fade away once more?
Look, those tanks? Acid. Strong enough to kill anything, no matter its biology. They wouldn't have installed that if they weren't afraid of the consequences of her getting loose.
Commander, there's some old grudges in the galaxy. Grudges humans should stay out of. If we kill her, we kill the entire race.
Your companions hear the truth. You have the power to free us or return our people to the silence of memory.
If I let you live, would you attack other races again?
No. I do not know what happened in the war. We only heard discordance, songs the color of oily shadows. We would seek a hidden place to teach our children harmony. If they understand, perhaps we would return.
Are you a survivor from the war? A clone?
We do not know. We were only an egg, hearing mother cry in our dreams. A tone from space hushed one voice after another. It forced the singers to resonate with its own sour yellow note. Then we awoke in this place, the last echo of those who came out from the singing planet. The sky is silent.
I won't destroy your entire race. You'll go free.
You will give us the chance to compose anew? We will remember. We will sing of your forgiveness to our children.
Are you here to secure the situation?
How are you holding up?
You must listen to me. If we do not contain our mistake, they will drop bombs from the battle stations. You understand?
You let these things out?
I am only following the orders. Binary Helix found an egg. It was on a derelict ship, thousands of years drifting. This was Ragnar's ship. Inside they find many eggs in cryogenic suspension.
A thousand-year-old egg hatched?
Yes. Very tough to be so long frozen. That it survived the centuries, this is miraculous. Binary Helix planned to clone Ragnar, mass produce them, create an army. But when they get here, they find this egg is not a common Ragnar. It is a queen. After she lays eggs, they move her to Rift Station. They are thinking that without her, they can raise the babies to be obedient.
Hold on. Don't you need a male to get eggs?
Queens are born carrying the genetic code of their fathers. Eggs are carried away from the colony to hatch alone. Queens can lay eggs in hours and have a colony in days. This is how they spread so quickly.
Separating them from their mother didn't work.
This was exactly the wrong thing to do. I am thinking that without a queen, Ragnar do not develop properly. Her mind is shaping theirs. These Ragnar are uncontrollable.
This is fascinating, but we don't have time to chat.
These Ragnar are beyond saving. It is a sad thing, but they must be euthanized. I am thinking that the neutron purge must be set off.
I'm not familiar with the purge system.
It creates bursts of neutron radiation, kills everything within the station. Things beyond get genetic damage of varying degree.
How do we set off the purge?
Arming controls are nearby. All you do is insert the key. Then I will give Mira destruct.
Connecting. I have full access to the facility and am at your disposal.
Activate the neutron purge.
I'm sorry, but I can't do that without proper code authorization.
Code input 875020079. Code Omega local execution.
Verified. Code Omega execution in 120 seconds.
What's our next move, Commander? Head for the MEU relay?
The MEU relay could link to dozens of systems. Unless we know exactly where Saren's going, we'd just be wasting our time.
The Commander is right. We cannot rush off blind. We still need to learn more about Saren.
Who put you in charge? Did the Commander resign when I wasn't looking?
We're all on the same team here, Williams. She's just trying to help.
Sorry, Commander.
Look, this is a tough mission. We're all on edge. Everyone go get some rest. Crew dismissed.
Novaria report is away, Commander. You want me to patch it through to the Council?
Patch him through, Joker.
Setting up the link now, Commander.
This report accurate, Commander? You found Ragnar on Novaria?
And then released the Queen. Do you have any idea what you've done? How many generations until they overrun the galaxy?
This Queen is different. She understands why her kind had to be wiped out last time around.
I hope you're right, Shepard. My children's children will pay the price if you're not.
We'll be waiting for your next report, Commander.
We saw your ship. Fidan wants to speak with you immediately.
Who's Fidan?
He's our leader. He needs your help to prepare for the Geth. They're making another push. Please, up the stairs past the freighter.
Oh, Commander. I'm glad they finally sent somebody to help us.
You're a bit late, aren't you?
Arcelia. Sorry, Commander. Everyone's on edge since...
Watch out! We've got Geth in the tower!
Protect the heart of the colony!
The tower's secure. Thanks to you, Commander.
I'm just glad your colony's safe.
I appreciate your concern and your efforts against the Geth.
They may have been slowed, but they'll be back.
They always come back.
Help me find what the Geth are after and you'll all get out of here alive.
We don't know what they're after. They came, they attacked us, that's all we know. Their main base is at the Exogeni headquarters. A good place to start looking if you want answers.
What's Exogeni?
It's the company most of us work for before the attacks. They fund this colony. The Skyway leads directly to Exogeni headquarters. You can't miss it.
Of course, there's an army of Geth between here and there.
I didn't expect this would be easy.
Then maybe I can get this colony operational again.
What can you tell me about the defenses the Geth have set up?
I don't have any details, but I'll wager it's a lot more fortified than the command post.
They landed at least one Geth ship at Exogeni, and I've seen large walking tanks on the Skyway. Expect a hard fight.
The Normandy isn't huge, but we could airlift you out.
The Geth fighters are too dangerous, and I won't be driven off this world. It is our home. There's a chance for growth here that's simply not available on other worlds.
I'll talk to you when I learn more.
Damn it! I'm so sorry. I thought you were Geth, or one of those Baron.
You're safe now. But why were you here in the first place?
It's my own fault. Everyone else was running, and I stayed to back up data. Next thing I knew, the Geth ship latched on, and the power went out. I was trapped. I tried to get out, but the way was blocked.
We'll get you out as soon as we find out what the Geth are after.
It's not the Geth. It's the energy field they put up. They don't want anyone else getting access to the...
I'm here for the Geth. It's very important that I find out what they're after.
I don't know for certain, but I'm guessing they're here for the Thorian.
Thorian? What is that, exactly?
It's an indigenous life form. Exogeni was studying it.
What else can you tell me? Do you know where I can find this Thorian?
I might be able to, but not with those Geth crawling around everywhere. Look, we need to get out of here, past that field.
Do you know how we can shut it down?
No, not exactly. But I think the Geth ship is powering it. I've noticed the Geth laying power cables everywhere. You can follow those cables, but there's Geth all over the place.
Tell me about yourself.
I'm just a research assistant for Exogeni. I came here with my mother. I don't even know if she made it out alive.
She's with some others from the colony. She's safe for now.
She's alive? Oh, thank God. I thought I was the only one left. Please, Commander, just get that field down so I can see my mother again.
Tell me what you know about the Thorian.
I really don't know that much about it. I think it's some kind of plant being. I know it's very old. Thousands of years, even.
Why do you think the Geth would be interested in the Thorian?
It's just a plant. I don't know why the Geth would care. Exogeni was studying it, but I don't think they found anything special.
You stay put. I'll go open some doors.
Oh, here, take my ID. This should get you past any locked doors.
I am unable to comply. Please contact your supervisor.
Damn it! Tell me what I want or I'll blast your virtual ass into actual dust!
Please contact your supervisor for a level 4 security exemption or make an appointment with...
Stupid machine!
If there is nothing else, please step aside. There is a queue forming behind you for the use of this console. Exogeni Corporation reminds all staff that the discharging of weapons while on company property is strictly forbidden. Welcome back, Research Assistant Elizabeth Bainham. What can I do for you?
What information was the last user attempting to access?
Fetching data. The previous user was attempting to access details on the study of subject species 37, the Thorian.
Tell me everything you told the Krogan.
I was unable to provide the previous user with any relevant data. Aside from lacking proper access, there has been no new data available on species 37. All sensors monitoring the observation post at Zoo's Hope have been inactive for several cycles.
What does Zoo's Hope have to do with the Thorian?
Species 37 is located within the substructure of the Zoo's Hope outpost.
Tell me everything you know about the Thorian.
The Thorian is a simple plant life form that exhibits a sentient behavior uncommon with other flora. Through dispersion and the eventual inhalation of spores, it can affect and control other organisms, including humans. The Zoo's Hope control group has yielded interesting results. Before sensors went offline, almost 85% of all test subjects were infected.
Are you saying Exogeny knew its people were getting infected?
It was deemed necessary to assess the true potential of Species 37.
It's no wonder they were behaving so oddly.
We should contact Joker.
Joker! Come in, Joker! Damn it! That field's blocking us.
We need to get that field down so we can get out of here and back to Zoo's Hope.
VI, what can you tell me about the Geth ship and the field it's generating?
I have limited data on the Geth. They have effectively blocked all sensors within the facility. I have detected unusual power fluctuations, but am unable to determine the source.
What do you know about the Geth?
I have no specifics on the Geth as they relate to this facility. All sensors have been purposely decommissioned since their arrival.
I want to know about Exogeny Corporation.
Exogeny Corporation is at the forefront of human expansion in the new galactic economy, funding colonial development and securing resource rights to ensure our progress as a species. Further inquiries regarding company policy may be directed to Consumer Information Services during regular business hours.
Who's in charge here? Who organized the research?
All decisions about local resource analysis and acquisition are made by on-site management, deferring to the board of directors only when seasonal quotas are missed or exceeded. Individual employee records are confidential.
Tell me about the Thorian.
Species 37 was discovered several weeks ago when a small team was infected with spores while examining ruins near the Zoo's Hope outpost. The outpost was quarantined immediately, and study of the infection began. Within 21 days, 58% of colonists exhibited altered behavior. Within 28 days, 85%.
What's the size of this thing?
The Thorian appears to be a diffused creature. Its cognitive abilities are centered in large nerve bundles, but it receives data from kilometers of meandering tendrils. We have discovered bundles approximately 1 meter in diameter, but these seem insufficient to coordinate the massive sensory potential it possesses. It may simply process such stimulation slowly, or perhaps there is a nerve cluster of a greater magnitude we have not yet encountered.
Do you know how the creature controls its slaves?
The will subversion manifests as intense pain if directives are ignored. The effect is severe enough that subjects are soon conditioned against even minor thoughts of rebellion. Observation suggests the Thorian views its thralls in a utilitarian way. Care is apparently taken to avoid injuring them, much as a craftsman avoids damaging his tools. As long as no action is taken against the creature's objectives, the subjects are free to pantomime a normal existence until specifically tasked with something.
Is it intelligent? Can I reason with it?
The Thorian does not exhibit the focused behavior of a predator. The release of spores is an act of survival, not aggression. It does trigger advanced behaviors in the humans it enslaves, but we have yet to discover whether it recognizes or is capable of recognizing humans as more than tools. It is sufficiently alien as to defy classification at this time.
Where's the center of this thing?
The Thorian is present as a weave of tendrils across much of the lower surface of Pharos. Observation of enslaved subjects suggests there may be key clusters that are tended by thralls. Unfortunately, direct observation of Species 37 is limited, or non-existent.
Please access my personal files.
Elizabeth Bainham, Research Assistant, Biomedical Division, Security Level 4 Exemption. You are currently under probation due to disagreements with management over established company policy. These sanctions may be lifted if your next evaluation is more agreeable.
What triggered the probation?
You were marked as combative about the operations of the Zoo's Hope Project, specifically regarding the handling of the infected colonists. As a result, you were tasked with monitoring the safety of the colonists for the duration of the observation.
That's enough for now.
The Geth used these claws to anchor their ships to the sides of buildings.
Geth certainly aren't so. How do we cut the power if it's coming from the ship?
It will be difficult. We can check the other claws for weaknesses, but the Geth are very thorough.
What is this place? Almost looks like the Geth built themselves some kind of church.
The Geth blur the line between organic and synthetic life. It's natural to assume they seek understanding from a higher power.
Thank you.
Very good. The field barring the exit will be down. Now we can go deal with the Thorian creature.
Well, that got the job done.
I hope that ship was full of those Geth bastards.
I repeat, Normandy to shore party, are you reading? Anyone there? Normandy to shore party, come on, Commander, talk to me.
Is that you, Joker? What's going on over there?
We're in lockdown here, Commander. Something happened to the colonists. They're banging on the hull, trying to claw their way inside the ship. They're freaking out.
They can't do any real damage. We're on our way back. Just hold your position.
Okay. Well, we'll just wait right here for you, Commander.
This place will be crawling with Geth in a minute. Keep together and we'll get out of here in one piece.
There you are. We should get out of here. I don't think this place is safe.
I need some answers. You knew more about the Thorian than you let on.
I was afraid. I wanted to stop the tests, but they threatened me. Told me I'd be next. When the Geth attacked, I stayed behind to send a message to Colonial Affairs. I tried to tell them where to find the Thorian, but the power cut before I could send the message. I never meant for this to happen.
You did what you could. I'll help them if you can tell me where to find the Thorian.
The Thorian is underneath Zoo's Hope, but the entrance is blocked. The colonists covered it with the freighter just before the Geth attacked.
But why are the Geth after the Thorian? What could Saren want with it?
Well, it does have unique mind control capabilities. That's what Exogeny was interested in.
Normandy to shore party, come in.
What is it, Joker?
We're getting a lot of Geth comm chatter. Looks like they're headed your way.
Thanks for the heads up, Joker. You heard the man. Let's move out.
I'm coming with you. I might be able to help. Undo the mess I helped create.
You can't do this, Jong.
Everyone shut up! Let me think.
What's going on?
You won't get away with this.
Get her out of here!
Get away from her, you son of a bitch!
Lisbeth!
Damn it! Come out where I can see you! All of you! Shepard, damn it. I knew it was too much to hope the Geth would kill you. I found some interesting facts about you in the Exogeny database. I know what you did during the Blitz, but your heroics aren't needed here.
We can talk this out. Nobody needs to get hurt.
You don't understand. It's not that easy. Communications are back up. Exogeny wants this place purged.
This is a human colony, Jong. You can't just repurpose us.
It's not just you. There's something here far more valuable than a few colonists.
You're after the one unique thing Pharos has. The Thorian.
The what?
It's a telepathic life form living under Zoo's Hope. It's taking control of the colonists there. Exogeny knew all along.
You won't get away with this, Jong.
So you keep saying, but nobody's gonna miss a few colonists.
Can't you see the inherent potential in this colony? Think of the promotional opportunities.
Opportunities? What the hell are you talking about?
They recovered from an alien attack on a frontier world. Add that to your company profile.
Well, yeah. No one's ever gone broke playing the Champion of Humanity card.
Sadly, you'd probably make a killing. But if it will let us get back to our lives, I'm for it.
It just might work. Wait, no, but the infected colonists will throw a bit of a wrench in that plan. No, they need to disappear.
You can't just kill the colonists. It's not their fault.
If you kill only the Thorian, it might be enough to stop the infection. Maybe.
It's worth a try, but I don't know if I can avoid harming the colonists.
There has to be another way.
Maybe there is. Come and talk to me before you leave, Commander. I'm glad you've decided to help us. I think there's a way to avoid killing the colonists.
What'd you have in mind?
I think you could safely use a nerve agent to neutralize the colonists.
Like a gas grenade?
Releasing clouds of nerve gas doesn't seem like a particularly good idea.
It's not like it's weapons grade. The insecticide we use in the grow labs contains trace amounts of tetraclopine, a neuromuscular degenerator. If their nervous systems are already weakened, it may act as a paralyzing agent.
We might be able to adapt a concussion grenade to deploy it.
Sounds good. I'll do what I can.
Excellent. Thank you so much, Commander.
tried to fight it, but it gets in your head. You can't imagine the pain. I was supposed to be their leader. These people trusted me. It wants me to stop you, but I won't. I won't!
We just need to find this creature and determine what it... Kira, what is that?
That does not look like any plant I've ever seen. This may be problematic.
Invaders, your every step is a transgression. 1,000 feelers appraise you as meat, good only to dig or decompose. I speak for the old growth as I did for Saren. You are within and before the Thorian. It commands that you be in awe.
You gave something to Saren, something I need.
Saren sought knowledge of those who are gone. The old growth listened to flesh for the first time in the long cycle. Trades were made. Then Cold Ones began killing the flesh that would tend the next cycle. Flesh fairly given. The old growth sees the air you push as lies. It will listen no more.
I won't let you keep your thralls. Release them, now.
No more will the Thorian listen to those that scurry. Your lives are short, but have gone on too long. I should thank you for releasing me.
Is everything all right? Are you hurt?
I am fine, or I will be, in time. My name is Shiala. I served Matriarch Benezia. When she allied herself with Saren, so did I. Benezia foresaw the influence Saren would have. She joined him to guide him down a gentler path. But Saren is compelling. Benezia lost her way.
Are you saying Saren can control minds?
Benezia underestimated Saren, as I did. We came to believe in his cause and his goals. The strength of his influence is troubling.
She tried to manipulate Saren, but in the end, her plan backfired.
Asari matriarchs are among the most intelligent and powerful beings in the galaxy. How could one fall under Saren's control?
Saren has a vessel, an enormous warship unlike anything I've ever seen. He calls it Sovereign. It can dominate the minds of his followers. They become indoctrinated to Saren's will. The process is subtle. It can take days, weeks, but in the end, it is absolute. I was a willing slave when Saren brought me to this world. He needed my biotics to communicate with the Thorian to learn its secrets. Saren offered me in trade. I was sacrificed to secure an alliance between Saren and the Thorian.
Saren's pretty quick to betray his own people.
He was quick to betray the Thorian, too. After he had what he wanted, he ordered the Geth to destroy all evidence of his existence. Saren knows you are searching for the conduit. He knows you are following his steps. He attacked the Thorian so you could not gain the cipher.
What's the cipher? And why did Saren need it?
The beacon on Eden Prime gave you visions. But the visions are unclear, confusing. They were meant for a Prothean mind. To truly comprehend them, you must think like a Prothean. You must understand their culture, their history, their very existence. The Thorian was here long before the Protheans built this city. It watched and studied them. When they died, it consumed them. They became a part of it.
So the Thorian taught Saren to think like a Prothean. How?
The cipher is the very essence of being a Prothean. It cannot be described or explained. It would be like describing color to a creature without eyes. To understand, you must have access to endemic ancestral memory, a viewpoint spanning thousands of Prothean generations. I sensed this ancestral memory, the cipher, when I melded with the Thorian. Our identities merged, our minds intertwined. Such knowledge cannot be taught. It simply exists.
I need that knowledge to stop Saren.
There is a way. I can transfer the knowledge from my mind to yours, as I did with Saren. Try to relax, Commander. Slow, deep breaths. Let go of your physical shell. Reach out to grasp the threads that bind us, one to another. Every action sends ripples across the galaxy. Every idea must touch another mind to live. Each emotion must mark another's spirit. We are all connected. Every living being united in a single, glorious existence. Open yourself to the universe, Commander. Embrace eternity. I have given you the cipher, just as it was given to Saren. The ancestral memories of the Protheans are part of you now.
What just happened? Are you okay?
I saw something. It still didn't make any sense.
You have been given a great gift, the experience of an entire people. It will take time for your mind to process this information.
You look pretty rough. We should get you back to the ship.
I'm sorry if you have suffered, but there was no other way. You needed the cipher. In time, it will help you understand the vision from the beacon.
Do you know what the conduit is, or where it is?
No, I'm sorry. All I know is that Saren believes the conduit was the key to the Prothean extinction.
Well, then whatever it is, we can't let him have it.
You have the cipher. In time, your visions will clear. They will lead you to the conduit. I only pray you find it before Saren does.
Is there anything else you can tell me about the Thorian?
When the creature enveloped me, I became part of it. But I still don't truly understand it. So alien, so ancient. Its exact age is impossible to know. It measured time differently. 10,000 years of hibernation broken by a few frantic centuries of activity. Its mind was awesome, magnificent. It transcended all classification. And now it is gone.
Don't tell me you feel sorry for that thing.
The Thorian was a unique life form. A sentient being that lived for 50,000 years, maybe more. There is nothing even remotely like it in the known galaxy. I'm grateful you saved me from a life of thraldom. Yet I cannot help but feel some sorrow for the loss of such a rare and remarkable creature.
What else can you tell me about Saren?
There is little I could tell you that you do not already know. He's powerful, he's charismatic. And he is dangerous. Once I followed him, blind to his true nature. But now I see he is leading the galaxy into an age of darkness and suffering.
I want to know more about you.
There is nothing remarkable about me. I was merely one of Matriarch Benezia's disciples. For nearly two centuries, I followed her, learning at her feet. When Benezia revealed her plan to join Saren, she gave her disciples a choice. Only those who were willing had to follow her. Many felt her plan was too dangerous. But I believed in her. I thought she could turn Saren away from his insanity. Instead, we joined him in it.
Now that you're free of the Thorian, what are you planning to do next?
If you allow it, I would like to stay here with the colonists. They have suffered greatly, and I've played a role in their suffering. I would like to make amends.
The colonists will need all the help they can get. They'll be happy to have you on their side.
Thank you, Commander. May fortune smile upon you.
Can't believe it. Zhong says we'll have all the money we need to keep this place running.
I will do what I can to assist the colony in this difficult time. I am ashamed of the damage done to the lives of these people.
Farewell, Shiala.
Farewell, Commander. I wish you well in your hunt.
Commander, you look pale. Are you suffering any ill effects from the cipher?
The cipher shook me up a bit.
I might be able to help you. I am an expert on the Protheans. If I join my consciousness to yours, maybe we can make some sense of it.
Do it. Hurry. We don't have much time.
Relax, Commander. Embrace eternity! That was incredible. All this time, all my research, yet I never dreamed. I am sorry. The images were so vivid. I never imagined the experience would be so intense. You are remarkably strong-willed, Commander. What you have been through, what you have seen, would have destroyed a lesser mind.
Did you see anything?
The beacon on Eden Prime must have been badly damaged. Large parts of the vision are missing. The data transferred into the Commander's mind is incomplete.
You must have seen something.
I was able to interpret the data relayed through your vision, what was there at least. But something was missing. Saren must have the missing information. Maybe he found another beacon. If we can find the missing data from your vision, I can... Oh. I am sorry. The joining is exhausting. I should go to the medical bay and lie down for a moment.
We're done here. Dismissed.
I've sent off the Pharos report, Commander. You want me to patch you through to the Council?
Patch him through, Joker.
Setting up the link now, Commander.
Commander, Exogenia should have told us about the Thorian. It would have made your job much easier.
You might have been able to capture it for study instead of destroying it.
The Thorian liked to enslave minds. Anyone who studied it would have ended up as one of its thralls.
Perhaps it's for the best, then. At least the colony was saved.
Of course it was saved. Shepard would go to any lengths to help a human colony.
Being human had nothing to do with it. They were in trouble.
Admirable. But sometimes Spectres have to make sacrifices. I hope you're willing to do that when the time comes.
Goodbye, Commander. We will be waiting for your next report.
I saw your Ferris report. If we had known anything about the Thorian, Exogeni would never have been given the permits to start a colony there. Thank God the colony survived. We can't afford to have too many failures out in the Traverse. It's one of our major expansion regions.
You don't give a damn about the colonists. It's all just politics to you, isn't it?
We can't all be the hero who charges in to save the day, Commander. But we each serve humanity in our own way. You can't escape interstellar politics. It's part of the big picture. And sometimes it isn't pretty.
Just ignore him, Shepard. The Ambassador's a little bitter sometimes. Comes with the job.
Commander Shepard, we've received information that may be critical to your mission against Saren.
I'll take all the help I can get.
We've received an urgent message from one of our infiltration regiments in the Traverse.
You mean spies?
Spectres tend to attract attention, Commander. But they are only one arm of the Council. Special task groups are often a better option for monitoring developing situations.
We currently have several infiltration units scattered throughout the border regions of Citadel space. This particular unit was gathering intel on Saren.
What did they find?
Unfortunately, the message we received was little more than static. The infiltration team must be in a situation where they can't set up proper interstellar communications. But the message was sent on a channel reserved for mission-critical communications. Whatever they were trying to tell us, we know it was important. Considering your interest in Saren, We thought you might want to investigate this. Find out what happened to our team. The signal originated from the planet Vermeer.
I'll look into it.
The Council prefers not to become involved in the specifics of Spectre activities. We only want you to be aware of all your options, including Vermeer. Good luck, Commander Shepard. We will keep you advised if we learn anything else.
Commander, I'm reading a signal. Must be our Solarian infiltrators.
Check out those defense towers.
Drop the Mako. We'll go in hot and take them out.
I'll get you in underneath their radar, Commander. Got a clean drop, Commander.
Stay out of range and continue evasive maneuvers until I bring those AA towers down.
I know the drill. Meet you at the camp once those towers are offline. Joke around. I'm reading that the grid is down, Commander. On approach to the Solarian base now. Out.
Ready to move out, Commander.
That must be the Solarian camp.
So what are we supposed to do now?
Stay put until we can come up with a plan.
Are you in charge here? What's the situation?
I'm Captain Kirahi, 3rd Infiltration Regiment STG. You and your crew have just landed in the middle of a hot zone. Every AA gun within 10 miles has been alerted to your presence.
Oh, that's just great. What now?
We stay put until the Council sends the reinforcements we requested.
We are the reinforcements.
What? You're all they sent? I told the Council to send a fleet.
We couldn't understand your transmission. They sent me to investigate.
That is a repetition of our task. I lost half my men investigating this place.
So what have you found?
Saren's base of operations. He set up a research facility here, but it's crawling with Geth and very well fortified.
Is he here? Have you seen him?
No, but his Geth are everywhere and we've intercepted some comms referring to Saren. This is his facility, there's no doubt about that.
What's Saren researching?
He's using the facility to breed an army of Krogan.
How is that possible?
Apparently, Saren has discovered a cure for the genophage.
What's so important about curing this genophage?
It was the solution to the Krogan problem.
We introduced the genophage to the Krogan population after the uprising, to quell their numbers. Without it, the Krogan will quickly overrun the galaxy. And these Krogan follow Saren.
The Geth are bad enough, but a Krogan army... he'd be almost unstoppable.
Exactly my thoughts. We must ensure that this facility and its secrets are destroyed.
Destroyed? I don't think so. Our people are dying. This cure can save them.
If that cure leaves this planet, the Krogan will become unstoppable. We can't make the same mistake again.
We are not a mistake.
Is he going to be a problem? We already have enough angry Krogan to deal with.
He'll be fine. I'll talk to him.
I'd appreciate that, Commander. My men and I need to rethink our plan of attack. Can you give us some time?
Go ahead, Captain. I'll come back soon.
We won't be long, Commander. In the meantime, if you need any supplies, you can talk to Commander Rentola. He's in one of the tents nearby.
Looks like things are a bit of a mess.
Yeah. I wouldn't be so worried if it wasn't for Rex. He looks like he's gonna blow a gasket.
You think I should go talk to him?
It wouldn't hurt. Well, it might, actually. Just do it carefully.
I'll be careful. But be ready, just in case.
This isn't right, Shepard. If there's a cure for the genophage, we can't destroy it.
I understand you're upset, but we both know Saren's the enemy here. He's the one you should be angry with.
Really? Saren created a cure for my people. You want to destroy it. Help me out here, Shepard. The lines between friend and foe are getting a little blurry from where I stand.
This isn't a cure, it's a weapon, and if Saren is allowed to use it, you won't be around to reap the benefits. None of us will.
That's a chance we should be willing to take. This is the fate of my entire people we're talking about. I've been loyal to you so far. Hell, you did more for me than my family ever did. But if I'm going to keep following you, I need to know we're doing it for the right reasons.
Rex, these Krogan are not your people. They're slaves of Saren, tools. Is that what you want for them?
No, we were tools for the Council once. To thank us for wiping out the Rachni, they neutered us all. I doubt Saren will be as generous. All right, Shepard. You've made your point. I don't like this, but I trust you enough to follow your lead. Just one thing. When we find Saren, I want his head.
Thank you for speaking with the Krogan. The assault on Saren's base will be difficult enough as it is.
I assume that means you've come up with a plan.
Of sorts. We can convert our ship's drive system into a 20-kiloton ordnance. Crude, but effective.
Nice. Drop that nuke from orbit, and Saren can kiss his Turian ass goodbye.
Unfortunately, the facility is too well fortified for that. We'll need to place the bomb at a precise location.
Where do we take the nuke, and how do we get there?
The bomb must be taken to the far side of the facility. Your ship can drop it off, but we'll need to infiltrate the base, disable the AA guns, and pacify any ground forces first.
You want us to go in on foot? We don't have enough men.
It does sound a bit risky. Is there no other way?
No, but I think we can work around that. I'm going to divide my men into three teams and hit the front of the facility. While we've got their attention, you can sneak your shadow team in the back.
It's a good idea, but your people are going to get slaughtered.
We're tougher than we look, Commander. But it's true. I don't expect many of us will make it out alive. And that makes what I'm going to ask even more difficult. I need one of your men to accompany me, to help coordinate the teams.
We'll need someone who knows Alliance communication protocols.
I volunteer, Commander.
Not so fast, LT. Commander Shepard will need you to arm the nuke. I'll go with the Salarians.
With all due respect, Gunnery Chief, it's not your place to decide.
Why is it that whenever someone says, with all due respect, they really mean kiss my ass?
Who would be better suited to the mission?
Either of these two will do, Commander. Both seem willing to sacrifice their lives if necessary, though if we are lucky, such sacrifices won't be required.
Williams, you'll accompany the captain. No heroics, understood?
Aye, aye, Commander.
I will have the ordnance loaded onto the Normandy and brief your crew on its detonation sequencing. Do you have any questions before we go, Commander?
The Normandy's picking me up. How will your teams escape the blast?
We will engage the Geth as long as possible. Once the bomb is in place, we will fall back to try and escape the blast radius. If we move quickly, we should be able to escape with acceptable casualties. If not, then our memories will live on as martyrs to a greater cause.
You talk like this is a suicide mission.
I won't lie to you, Commander. There is a chance none of us will survive this assault, even your team. But we do what is necessary.
Shadow seems clear enough. What would the other teams be called?
Eigor, Manavai, and Jeeto. They were the initial settlements on our first three colony worlds. They are at the heart of Salarian territory to this day. These names will remind my men what they are fighting for. They must have a personal stake in the fight if we are to have any chance of success.
Give me a quick rundown of the plan again.
You are Team Shadow. We will create a distraction while you... Disable the AA guns so the norm... Once you have the bomb, place it next to the geothermal taps. Then get out before it detonates.
I want to know more about the bomb. How reliable is it going to be?
Its reliability depends on the person arming it, but it will do the job. The drive system is highly impervious to damage from external sources. Once it has been armed, very little can stop it. The key is getting it into place and armed before the Geth can stop us.
I'm ready when you are, Captain.
Excellent. Then if you'll excuse me, I need to prepare my men.
Well, this is it. Don't do anything stupid while I'm gone, LT. You too, Commander.
We'll be fine. You'll see.
Yeah, I just... Good luck.
Is there something you want to say, Chief?
I don't know. It's just weird. Going under someone else's command. I've got used to working with you. All of you.
Don't worry. We'll see you on the other side.
I know. It's been an honor serving with you, Commander.
It doesn't matter if we're not in the same unit. We are still a team. Watch each other's backs, keep your eyes open, and fight like I know you can. We'll all come out of this in one piece.
You bet, Commander.
You all know the mission and what is at stake. I have come to trust each of you with my life, but I have also heard murmurs of discontent. I share your concerns. We are trained for espionage. We would be legends, but the records are sealed. Glory in battle is not our way. Think of our heroes. The Silent Step, who defeated a nation with a single shot. Or the Ever Alert, who kept armies at bay with hidden facts. These giants do not seem to give us solace here, but they are not all that we are. Before the network, there was the fleet. Before diplomacy, there were soldiers.
Our influence stopped the Rachni, but before that, we held the line. Our influence stopped the Krogan, but before that, we held the line. Our influence will stop Saren. In the battle today, we will hold the line.
Good luck, Commander. I hope we will meet again.
Comm check. Do you read me, Commander?
Loud and clear.
Good. We'll start our push. We'll try to make it to the AA guns, but it might be up to you to finish the job. And Commander, if you see any way to undermine their defenses, we could definitely use the help.
Mono Vi is under coordinated crossfire. Check for long-range turrets helping the Geth target.
They're calling SAT strikes. Dieto, watch for comm stations. Williams, can you see anything?
I smell...
Aircraft heading to perimeter stations to recharge. Bunker up before they come back.
Air threat is not materialized. We may be getting some help.
We've got access to base security. Should be able to cut the alarms from here, might even be able to trigger alarms on the far side of the base. It'll clear the guards out for us, but they might be too much for Williams and the Solarians to handle.
Just disable the alarms. We can handle any guards inside.
Give a little ground, Williams. We don't want them to bunker up. Draw them out.
Well, you're not a Geth, and you're not wearing a lab coat. I guess I'm glad to see you. Lieutenant Gonto Imnes of the 3rd Infiltration Regiment, captured during recon. I assume the fleet was called in to destroy the base?
The transmission wasn't clear. The fleet's not coming.
I see. Then you must be the infiltration team. I know the captain. He will want this facility destroyed. My team was altered, indoctrinated. He knew about the breeding grounds. But the indoctrination is a greater threat, and far more horrifying. I watched good people reduced to mindless husks. There isn't anything like it. Others died during the experiments. I envy them.
Do you know anything about the experiments they were conducting?
They were studying indoctrination. Symptoms, progress. Saren uses it to control his people, but I don't think he fully understands it. I don't know much else. I just saw what it did to the others. Turned them into empty husks. I can't end up like that, please. Let me out.
I'm opening your cell, but then you're on your own.
Don't look back and hope you'll outrun the blast, hmm? A better chance than I had before you showed up. Thank you, human. And good luck. You'll need it.
These look docile. Their minds are gone.
Why did Saren do this? To steal a man's mind like that is disgusting.
Open the doors. Give them a chance to outrun the blast.
Are you sure, Shepard? At best, they might hurt themselves. If there is any sense left in them, they might be directed to harm us.
Leave them. Let's get moving.
It's safest, but I would prefer they be put out of their misery.
Don't shoot! Please, I just want to get out of here before it's too late.
I'm not gonna hurt you. Who are you?
Ranathanoptis, neurospecialist. But this job isn't worth dying over, or worse. You think the indoctrination only affects prisoners? Sooner or later, Saren will want to dissect my brain, too.
Give me one reason I should help you.
I can help you. This elevator behind me goes to Saren's private lab. I can get you in. See? Full access. All of Saren's private files. Are we good? Can I go?
What were you studying here?
It's that ship, Sovereign. It emits some kind of signal. Undetectable, but it's there. I've seen the effects. Saren uses it to influence his followers, to control them. It's called indoctrination. Direct exposure to the signal turns you into a mindless slave, like the Solarian test subjects. But there's collateral damage, too.
What do you mean by collateral damage?
Sovereign's signal is too strong. Spend too much time near the ship and you feel it, like a tingle at the back of the skull. It's like a whisper you can't quite hear. You're compelled to do things, but you don't know why. You just obey. Eventually, you just stop thinking for yourself. It happens to everyone at the facility. My first test subject was the man I replaced. Now I just want to get out of here before it happens to me.
Why is Saren researching this? Isn't he the one controlling it?
The signal comes from the ship. It makes us obey Saren, but I don't think he controls it. Not exactly. I think he's scared it might be affecting him. Indoctrination is subtle. By the time the effects become noticeable, it's usually too late.
Tell me more about this signal.
Signal's not exactly the right word. There's some kind of energy field emanating from the ship. It changes thought patterns. Over time, days, maybe a week, it weakens your will. You become easier to manipulate and control, but it's a degenerative condition. There's a balance between control and usefulness. The less freedom a subject maintains, the less capable it becomes.
I'm gonna blow this place to hell and gone. If you want to make it out alive, you better start running.
What? You can't... But I'll never... Oh!
You enjoyed that.
I get the feeling something bad is about to happen.
You are not Saren.
What is that? Some kind of VI interface?
Rudimentary creatures of blood and flesh. You touch my mind, fumbling in ignorance, incapable of understanding.
I don't think this is a VI.
There is a realm of existence so far beyond your own, you cannot even imagine it. I am beyond your comprehension. Sovereign.
Sovereign isn't just some Reaper ship Saren found. It's an actual Reaper.
Reaper, a label created by the Protheans to give voice to their destruction. In the end, what they chose to call us is irrelevant. We simply are.
The Protheans vanished 50,000 years ago. You couldn't have been there. It's impossible.
Organic life is nothing but a genetic mutation. An accident. Your lives are measured in years and decades. You wither and die. We are eternal, the pinnacle of evolution and existence. Before us, you are nothing. Your extinction is inevitable. We are the end of everything.
There is an entire galaxy of races united and ready to face you.
Confidence born of ignorance. The cycle cannot be broken.
Cycle? What cycle?
The pattern has repeated itself more times than you can fathom. Organic civilizations rise, evolve, advance, and at the apex of their glory, they are extinguished. The Protheans were not the first. They did not create the Citadel. They did not forge the mass relays. They merely found them. The legacy of my kind.
Why would you construct the mass relays, then leave them for someone else to find?
Your civilization is based on the technology of the mass relays. Our technology. By using it, your society develops along the paths we desire. We impose order on the chaos of organic evolution. You exist because we allow it, and you will end because we demand it.
They're harvesting us, letting us advance to the level they need, then wiping us out!
What do you want from us? Slaves? Resources?
My kind transcends your very understanding. We are each a nation, independent. Free of all weakness. You cannot even grasp.
grasp the nature of our existence.
Where did you come from? Who built you?
We have no beginning. We have no end. We are infinite. Millions of years after your civilization has been eradicated and forgotten, we will endure.
Where are the rest of the Reapers? Are you the last of your kind?
We are Legion. The time of our return is coming. Our numbers will darken the sky of every world. You cannot escape your doom.
You're not even alive. Not really. You're just a machine. Machines can be broken.
Your words are as empty as your future. I am the vanguard of your destruction. This exchange is over.
Commander, we got trouble.
Hit me, Joker.
That ship Sovereign? It's moving. I don't know what you did down there, but that thing just pulled a turn that would shear any of our ships in half. It's coming your way, and it's coming hard. We need to wrap things up in there fast.
This console is shot. Orders, Commander?
Let's head to the breeding facility. Joker can pick us up after we set the nuke.
The Geth are turning from your position, J.S.O. Looks like Shadow picked a sensitive spot. Williams, head them off. Hold them. That's it. We need to clear the gap and set those charges. Charges set. Everyone bunker down. Bunker down.
All right. Nice work. That's one less thing to worry about. Commander, I'm bringing us in. I'll get as close to the site as I can.
Bomb is in position. We're all set here.
Commander, can you read me?
The nuke is almost ready. Get to the rendezvous point, Williams.
Negative, Commander. The Geth have us pinned down on the AA tower. We've taken heavy casualties. We'll never make the rendezvous point in time.
Get them out of there, Joker, now!
Negative. It's too hot. Can't risk it. We'll hold them off as long as we...
It's okay, Commander. I need a couple of minutes to finish arming the bomb. Go get them and meet me back here.
Up to the AA tower. Move!
Reinforcements. We better hurry.
Heads up, LT. We just spotted a troop ship headed to your location.
It's already here. There's Geth pouring out all over the bombsite.
Can you hold them off?
There's too many. I don't think we can survive until you get here. I'm activating the bomb.
Alenka, what are you doing?
I'm just making sure this bomb goes off. No matter what. It's done, Commander. Go get Williams and get the hell out of here.
Screw that. We can handle ourselves. Go back and get Alenko.
Alenko, radio Joker and tell him to meet us at the bomb site.
Yes, Commander. I...
You know it's the right choice, LT.
I'm sorry, Ash. I had to make a choice.
I understand, Commander.
Fire! Cover your flank! Cover your...
Geth were utterly convinced the Salarians were the real threat. An impressive diversion. Of course, it was all for nothing. I can't let you disrupt what I've accomplished here. You can't possibly understand what's really at stake.
Why are you doing this?
You've seen the vision from the beacons, Shepard. You of all people should understand what the Reapers are capable of. They cannot be stopped. Do not mire yourself in pointless revolt. Do not sacrifice everything for the sake of petty freedoms. The Protheans tried to fight, and they were utterly destroyed. Trillions dead. But what if they had bowed before the invaders? Would the Protheans still exist? A submission not preferable to extinction.
Do you really believe the Reapers will let us live?
Now you see why I never came forward with this to the Council. We Organics are driven by emotion instead of logic. We will fight even when we know we cannot win. But if we work with the Reapers, if we make ourselves useful, think how many lives could be spared. Once I understood this, I joined Sovereign, though I was aware of the dangers. I had hoped this facility could protect me.
You're afraid Sovereign is influencing you. You're afraid he's controlling your thoughts.
I've studied the effects of indoctrination. The more control Sovereign exerts, the less capable the subject becomes. That is my saving grace. Sovereign needs me to find the conduit. My mind is still my own, for now. But the transformation from ally to servant can be subtle. I will not let it happen to me.
Why are the Geth following Sovereign?
They believe Sovereign to be some kind of god, the pinnacle of their own evolution. But the reaction of their deity is most telling. It is insulted. Sovereign does not desire the pitiful devotions the Geth hurl at it. They are just tools, and no amount of belief on their part will change that. But as tools, they are useful. They will survive the coming invasion. If organic life is to survive, we must also prove we are useful. We must work with the Reapers.
Tell me why Sovereign needs the conduit. Tell me what it is. Maybe we can find a way to stop them.
The conduit is the key to your destruction and my salvation. Sovereign needs my help to find it. That is the only reason I have not been indoctrinated.
Sovereign's manipulating you and you don't even know it. You're already under its power.
No, Sovereign needs me. If I find the conduit, I've been promised a reprieve from the inevitable. This is my only hope.
Together, we can stop Sovereign. We don't have to submit to the Reapers. We can beat them.
I no longer believe that, Shepard. Visions cannot be denied. The Reapers are too powerful. The only hope of survival is to join with them. Sovereign is a machine. It thinks like a machine. If I can prove my value, I become a resource worth maintaining. There is no other logical conclusion.
You were a specter. You were sworn to defend the galaxy. Then you broke that vow to save yourself.
I'm not doing this for myself. Don't you see? Sovereign will succeed. It is inevitable. My way is the only way any of us will survive. I'm forging an alliance between us and the Reapers. Between organics and machines. And in doing so, I will save more lives than have ever existed. But you would undo my work. You would doom our entire civilization to complete annihilation. And for that, you must die.
Thank you.
Can't believe that Ash didn't make it. How could we just leave her down there?
Williams knew the risks going in. She gave her life to save the rest of us.
But why me? Why not her?
I'm sorry, Caden. I'd never leave you behind. I couldn't. You know that.
I know. And I am grateful. But Ash died because of me. Because of us.
It wasn't your fault. It wasn't my fault. The only one to blame here is Saren.
Yes, ma'am. We'll get it done.
Commander, excuse me for interrupting, but I have an idea. I think the beacon you found in Saren's base was similar to the one you found on Eden Prime. It may have filled in the missing pieces of your vision. I might be able to help you put all those pieces together.
You want to join our minds again, don't you? Okay, go ahead.
Relax, Commander. Embrace eternity! Thought the images would be so intense. I need a moment to collect myself.
Did the vision make any sense to you?
It's a distress call. A message sent out across the Prothean Empire. A warning against the Reapers, but the warning came too late.
What about the conduit?
There were other images, locations, places I recognized from my research. Ilos! The conduit is on Ilos! That is why Saren needed to find the Mew Relay. It is the only way to get to Ilos.
How come you never told us about Ilos before?
The Mew Relay links to dozens of systems and hundreds of worlds. How was I to know Ilos was the one we wanted? Without the cipher, the images in your visions were never clear. Only now do I recognize them as landmarks from Ilos.
We need to get to Ilos.
Forget it. The Mew Relay's inside the Terminus systems. Alliance ships are not welcome there. Neither are Spectres.
The conduit's on Ilos. That's where Saren's heading. I'll be waiting for him when he gets there.
Saren will have his entire fleet orbiting Ilos. You will never make it down to the surface without reinforcements. You must alert the Council. We need a fleet to... Oh. I am sorry. The joining is... exhausting. I should go to the medical bay and lie down for a moment.
We're done here. Dismissed.
Commander, there's a comm buoy nearby. I can link us in if you want to report back to the Citadel Council. You know, to warn them about Sovereign.
Set the link up, Joker. They need to know.
Patching it through.
Commander Shepard, I'm pleased to see your mission on Vermeer was a success.
Saren is formidable enough without an army of Krogan serving under him.
The Krogan would have served Sovereign, a Reaper.
Yes, we saw mention of this on your report. Sovereign. Ascension machine. A true artificial intelligence. This news is quite alarming, if it turns out to be accurate.
Sovereign's a Reaper. Saren admitted it.
He's playing you, Shepard. Saren still has contacts on the Citadel. You probably saw your earlier reports. The ones talking about your vision and the Reapers.
It's highly possible Saren is using false information to throw you off balance. Our own intelligence has never turned up any corroborating information.
Sooner or later, you're gonna have to take something I say on faith, Counselor.
Try to see this from our perspective, Commander. Saren is a threat we can recognize. However, as far as we know, the Reapers only exist in your visions.
Our decisions affect trillions of lives. We cannot act on the accusations of a single person, even a Spectre. Not without solid evidence.
The Council cannot take any official action here. That is why we created the Spectres. You have the authority to act as you see fit.
If you truly believe Sovereign is the real threat, you must take whatever steps are necessary to stop it. And Saren.
Good luck, Commander. From all of us.
Ambassador Udino wants us to report back to the Citadel. The Council's massing a joint species fleet to deal with Saren and his Geth.
I knew they'd come around. Back to the Citadel, Joker. I want the Normandy at the head of that fleet.
Yes, ma'am.
Good job, Shepard. Thanks to you, the Council's finally taking real action against Saren.
The Ambassador is correct. If Saren is foolish enough to attack the Citadel, as you believe, we will be ready for him.
Patrols are stationed at every mass relay linking Citadel space to the Terminus systems.
You think a blockade's gonna stop him? He's on Ilos looking for the conduit right now. What are you doing about that?
Ilos is only accessible to the MEU relay, deep inside the Terminus systems, Commander. If we send a fleet in there, the only possible outcome is full-scale war.
Now is the time for discretion, Commander. Saren's greatest weapon was secrecy. Exposed, he is no longer a threat. This is over.
One ship going into the Terminus systems won't start a war. I can be discreet.
You detonated a nuclear device on Vermeer. I wouldn't call that discreet.
Your style served you well in the Traverse, Commander. We recognize that. But Ilos requires a deft touch. We have the situation under control.
Secrecy isn't his greatest weapon. The conduit is.
Saren is a master manipulator. The conduit is just a distraction from his real plan to attack the Citadel.
Sovereign's the real threat. Saren's just a servant of the Reapers.
Only you have seen the Reapers. And then only in visions. We won't invade the Terminus systems because of a dream.
If Saren finds the conduit, we're all screwed. We have to go to Ilos.
Ambassador Udina, I get the sense Commander Shepard isn't willing to let this go.
There are serious political implications here, Shepard. Humanity's made great gains thanks to you, but now you're becoming more trouble than you're worth.
You bastard! You're selling us out!
It's just politics, Commander. You've done your job, now let me do mine. We've locked out all the Normandy's primary systems until further notice you're grounded.
Are you insane? After everything I have done, you still don't believe me.
I think it's time for you and your team to leave, Commander. This no longer concerns you. The Council can handle this, with my help, of course.
Commander, are you all right? I'm sure there's a way to appeal. We're under Alliance authority, after all, not the Council.
Official channels are closed. They were quite clear about that.
Closed? And we're supposed to accept that. So where do you think the best view will be when the Reapers roll through? If we have to sit it out, may as well get a good seat.
We're out of the game for now. I need you to be there while I figure things out.
You know you can count on me, or any of the crew, Commander.
Come on, Caden. I can get a salute from anyone on this ship. Sometimes I need a shoulder.
Yeah, I always leave a way out. You know that. I'm here for you, but we're in a rough spot, and the last thing I want to do is muddy things. If it's all that clear to start with, are we the pride of the fleet or not? Are we valued agents or just peons?
Can't just pull out a good old-fashioned, it'll be all right, can you?
It's that easy, huh? Okay, then. Everything will be fine, Shepard. You'll figure it out.
That wasn't so hard, now was it?
I could get used to it. I guess we have some downtime to figure out what we are, huh?
Sorry to interrupt, Commander. Got a message from Captain Anderson.
What did he want?
Only said to meet him in that club in the wards. Flux.
Well, I guess you better go then.
I'm glad you came, Shepard. I heard what happened.
They pulled me off the mission. Just like when they forced you to give up the Normandy.
I know, I'm sorry. I wanted to warn you, but there was no way to get a message to you before you docked. I know you're pissed off right now. But you can't give up. They all think this is over, but we both know it's not. You have to go to Ilos. You have to stop Saren from using the conduit.
There's only one ship that can get me into the Terminus systems undetected, and she's grounded.
Citadel controls locked out all the Normandy systems, but if we override the Ambassador's orders, we can get them to bring the Normandy back online. You can be in the Terminus systems before anyone even knows you're gone.
What's the plan?
I can unlock the Normandy from one of the consoles in the Citadel Control Center. You'll have a few minutes before anyone realizes what happened.
That's a restricted area, patrolled by armed guards. How are you going to get in?
Leave that to me. Just make sure you're in the Normandy when the systems come back online.
You're gonna get yourself killed. There has to be another way.
Ambassador Udina issued the lockdown order. If I can hack into the computer in his office, maybe I can override it.
He's not gonna let you waltz into his office and use his computer.
Hopefully he won't be there. If he is, I'll just have to think of something.
Udina won't let this slide, Captain. You'll be charged with treason, a capital offense.
We don't have a lot of options. I break into the Ambassador's computer, or I take my chances with the patrols in Citadel Control.
You'll have a better chance if you go after the Ambassador's computer.
I was hoping you'd say that. The Ambassador has made this personal. You ready to get the hell off this station, Commander?
Let's do it.
I'll take care of the lockdown. You get down to the Normandy and tell Joker to stand by.
Anderson? What are you doing here? I didn't send...
Let's go. Get us out of here, Joker. Now.
Commander?
You probably shouldn't call me that. I probably shouldn't even be wearing this uniform.
Yeah, hell of a thing. We broke our oath to defend the Alliance so we can keep it. What happens if this doesn't work out, Shepard? We mutinied, stole a prototype warship. If they wanted to get technical, they could throw in kidnapping. We're a hell of an example of humanity's best and brightest, huh?
I keep reminding myself we're doing the right thing. They don't believe me yet.
Well, if I didn't think you were doing the right thing, I wouldn't be here. It'll really hit the fan when we get to Ilos. If things don't go well, I want you to know... Well... I've enjoyed serving under you.
Caden, you stopped being a subordinate a long time ago. Don't you think it's time to act like it?
Battlefield flirting is one thing, Shepard. There are regs against fraternization. Well, I suppose breach of protocol will be pretty far down the list of charges at our courts-martial. You know what? You're right. About everything. I think about losing you, and I can't stand it. And the galaxy will just keep going. Everything, even the Reapers, will come around again. But you and I... We are important right now. And this is what will never happen again. Us. Shepard, you make me feel... human.
Bunk here tonight, Caden. With me.
Is that an order, Commander?
Caden, you make me feel like I could take on the universe. And right now, I kinda have to.
This can't change anything, Shepard. This is a good crew, the finest I've served with. I don't want to mess it up. It's been a long time since I've met a woman who,
Bridge to Commander Shepard. We're 5 minutes out from the MEU relay.
You know, I don't think I have all my stress worked out yet.
Joker's waiting for you on the bridge.
I swear, though, if anything happens to you, take care, Shepard.
Commander? We've got company.
Have their sensors picked us up yet?
Well, stealth systems are engaged. Unless we get close enough for a visual, they won't have any idea we're here.
Picking up some strange readings from the planet's surface.
Take us down, Joker. Lock in on the coordinates.
Negative on that, Commander. The nearest landing zone's 2 clicks away.
We'll never make it in time on foot. Get us something closer.
There is nowhere closer. I've looked!
Drop us in the Mako.
You need at least 100 meters of open terrain to pull off a drop like that. The most I can find near Saren is 20.
20 meters? We'll never get in close enough for a drop.
We have to try.
Find another landing zone.
There is no other landing zone!
The descent angle's too steep.
It's our only option.
It's not an option. It's a suicide run. We don't...
I can do it.
Joker?
I can do it.
Gear up and head down to the Mako. Joker, drop us right on top of that bastard.
We don't have time to admire the view. We have to get through that relay. And these Geth aren't gonna make it easy on us.
make it in time, Shepard.
In time for what?
The final confrontation. I think we both expected it would end like this. You've lost. You know that, don't you? In a few minutes, Sovereign will have full control of all the Citadel systems. The relay will open. The Reapers will return.
I've still got a few tricks up my sleeve.
You survived our encounter on Vermeier, but I've changed since then. Improved. Sovereign has upgraded me.
You let Sovereign implant you? Are you insane?
I suppose I should thank you, Shepard. After Vermeier, I couldn't stop thinking about what you said. About Sovereign manipulating me. About indoctrination. The doubts began to eat away at me. Sovereign sensed my hesitation. I was implanted to strengthen my resolve. Now my doubts are gone. I believe in Sovereign completely. I understand that the Reapers need organics. Join us, and Sovereign will find a place for you, too.
Sovereign's controlling you through your implants. Don't you see that?
The relationship is symbiotic. Organic and machine intertwined. A union of flesh and steel. The strengths of both, the weaknesses of neither. I am a vision of the future, Shepard. The evolution of all organic life. This is our destiny. Join Sovereign and experience a true rebirth.
Sovereign hasn't won yet. I can stop it from taking control of the station. Step aside and the invasion will never happen.
We can't stop it. Not forever. You saw the visions. You saw what happened to the Protheans. The Reapers are too powerful.
Some part of you must still realize this is wrong. You can fight this.
Maybe you're right. Maybe there is still a chance for implants. Sovereign is too strong. I'm sorry. It is too late for me.
It's not over yet. You can still redeem yourself.
Goodbye, Shepard. Thank you.
Systems.
Quick! Open the station's arms! Maybe the fleet can take Sovereign down before he regains control of the station!
See if you can open a communications channel.
The Destiny Ascension! Main drives offline, kinetic barriers down 40%. The Council is on board. I repeat, the Council is on board!
Normandy to the Citadel. Normandy to the Citadel. Please tell me that's you, Commander.
I'm here, Joker.
We caught that distress call, Commander. I'm sitting here in the Endura sector with the entire Arcturus fleet. We can save the Ascension. Just unlock the relays around the Citadel and we'll send the cavalry in.
Are you sure about this, Shepard? Human casualties will be very high if you send your fleet in now.
This is bigger than humanity. Sovereign's a threat to every organic species in the galaxy.
True. That's why you can't waste reinforcements trying to save the Council. You must hold them back until the Citadel arms open up and the human fleet can go after Sovereign.
What's the order, Commander? Come in now to save the Ascension, or hold back?
Opening the relays now, Joker. We need to save the Ascension, no matter what the cost.
I hope the Council appreciates this.
Alliance ships, move in. Save the Destiny Ascension.
Picking up reinforcements!
It's the Alliance! Thank the goddess!
Destiny Ascension, you are all clear. Repeat, you are all clear.
make sure he's dead.
Commander.
Ambassador, Captain, Commander Shepard. We have gathered here to recognize the enormous contributions of the Alliance forces in the war against Sovereign and the Geth.
Many humans lost their lives in the battle to save the Citadel. Brave and courageous soldiers who willingly gave their lives so that we, the Council, might live.
There is no greater sacrifice, and we share your grief over the tragic loss of so many noble men and women.
The Council also owes you a great personal debt, Commander, one we can never repay. You saved not just our lives, but the lives of billions from Sovereign and the Reapers.
Commander Shepard, your heroic and selfless actions serve as a symbol of everything humanity and the Alliance stand for.
And though we cannot bring back those valiant soldiers who gave their lives to save ours, we can honor their memories through our actions.
Humanity has shown it is ready to stand as a defender and protector of the galaxy. You have proved you are worthy to join our ranks and serve beside us on the Citadel Council.
Counselor, on behalf of humanity and the Alliance, we thank you for this prestigious honor and humbly accept.
We will need a list of potential candidates to fill humanity's seat on the Council.
Given all that has happened, I am sure your recommendation will carry a great deal of weight, Commander. Do you support any particular candidate?
We need someone with the courage to stand up for what he believes in. Someone like Captain Anderson.
Him? You must be joking. Anderson prefers to let his fists do the talking.
Only with you, Ambassador. Only with you.
Are you sure about this, Commander? The Captain's a soldier, not a politician.
We've already got too many politicians on the Citadel. The Captain would be perfect for this job.
I think it's an inspired choice. The Council would welcome him with open arms, should he accept.
I'm honored, Counselor. As humanity's representative, I'll do everything in my power to help the Council rebuild.
Sovereign's defeat marks the beginning of a new era for both humanity and the Council.
Sovereign was only a vanguard. The Reaper fleet is still coming. Hundreds of ships, maybe thousands. And I'm gonna find some way to stop them.
Shepard's right. Humanity is ready to do its part. United with the rest of the Council, we have the strength to overcome any challenge. When the Reapers come, we must stand side by side. We must fight against them as one. And together, we will drive them back into dark space.